Howard Stern all morning.
You know, the great Casanova?
Ah, yes.
That would have been me.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Classic rock and roll all day.
At the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes
should
it bright stars
should it
through the perilous fight
devastation
and hard to weave us
should it do us
so gallantly streaming and the rock
should it
do us
should it do us
should it
do us
the bombs
bursting in the air through the night.
Father said I can have anything I want.
Good for you and your father.
So guess what I want? A new brain. No, your bike. What's so funny, Pee-wee?
It's not for sale, Francis.
My father says everything's negotiable.
Pee-wee, I wouldn't sell my bike for all the money in the world. Not for $100 billion, $1 trillion.
Then you're crazy.
I know you are, but what am I?
You're a nerd.
I know you are, but what am I?
You're an idiot.
I know you are, but what am I?
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 I know you are, but what am I? Infinity.
No, I'm not.
You are.
No way.
Knock it off.
Cut it out.
Oh, shut up,
Pee-wee.
Why don't you make me?
Why don't you make me?
Because I don't make monkeys. I just train them.
Oh, Pee-wee, listen to reason. Oh, come on.
Listen to reason.
Pee-wee.
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
Everyone in Radioland knows that the most fun a disc jockey can have is sitting in on the Howard Stern Show. It's every DJ's dream to come in and chat with superstar Howard Stern. That's why Meg Griffin is the envy of every air personality.
Meg is here, Robin.
Oh, well, look at that.
Lucky Meg gets to exchange opinions with Howard every day.
There's just some stuff that's right and there's some stuff that's wrong, and we all have our own opinions on it, and that whole deal is way wrong.
You can always rely on cordial chit-chat when Meg pinpoints society's ills.
You've never been upset about nothing, Robin.
Wait, huh? You get upset because you see Sam's friends who you don't like their lifestyle? You mean you get upset?
I get upset with the carrying on as if it's something that should be credited and laughed at and la-di-da'd when people are dying as a result of some of this behavior. Yeah.
You think...
Okay, you want to get serious?
Yes, I do.
Meg is always in philosophical step with the program as she runs in each day to offer homespun wisdom.
Because I think sometimes you do anything on these airwaves to get ratings. And that upsets me, too.
Well, hey, let me tell you something.
No, there's nothing wrong with it. Nothing wrong with crack either, right? People like it, so let's push it.
Nothing wrong with crack?
Yeah, you see us doing that all the time?
Do I do crack?
Just because something's popular, it doesn't mean that it's good.
Whoa. Solid and flawless logic. That's why the Howard Stern Show is always quick to embrace a fellow DJ.
So Kinison's an evil man?
I don't like what he stands for.
What does he stand for?
What does he stand for? Nothing.
That's not true. Why would you say he's an evil man?
Abusing women.
Abusing women?
Being up for days on end out of his mind near a heart attack. Okay?
You're against his lifestyle, but you're for, like, when the Beatles and the Stones do it.
Right. I mean, when they're having five or six women in a room.
I don't see them doing that now, and I certainly don't put them on the air and make jokes about it and encourage it.
It's fun to hear friends having stable conversation.
When I walk in and see that garbage in the hallways, I'm going to get upset about it because I think it stinks.
And I think it's funny.
Well, I know you do. Everybody knows you do. It's Dante's Inferno in here.
Even tempered comments are in the air.
I am slowly taking over.
Oh, I know you are. People like you are taking over the world.
I am taking over the world, and I control the station now.
That's right. You probably do.
Respect for others' craft is the key to good working relationships.
I simply don't enjoy walking in on it as often as I do here.
Oh,
it stinks when you walk into this room after some of those shows.
You'll probably...
Yeesh. Calm the frig down, Meg. Have some fun, fun, fun.
Yeah, they know what they're doing. They look like they're about 16, and they don't have any clothes on. And they're dripping all over these pimp types.
So Lucky Meg gets to pick up the ball after Howard drops it. Yes, there's real philosophy going on here.
Oh, I am a mental case. I'll admit that.
No.
When she's not busy falling off her horse, Meg's having fun exchanges with America's hero on The Howard Stern Show.
It stinks. 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 It stinks.
Opportunity offender. The FCC called him on the carpet for his blue-tinged broadcast and these are the cue cards. You all can see it. They can't see it. Sorry. His blue-tinged broadcast on WXRK FM radio in New York caused a whole revolution in censorship. Let's welcome the meanest, nastiest, dirtiest DJ in the whole wide world, my man, Mr. Howard Stern.
Thank you. Rock, YSP, JFK, FM and AM in L.A. All right, 606, big show today. Lots of things going on, Rock.
No dial-a-date, though.
No, no. Don't worry about it. We'll work something else out. You'll see. It always works out. Well, sometimes it works out. It almost never works out. All right. We're going to take a short break. We're going to come back, take some of your phone calls, get this thing going. What? This wacky thing. Right after these words.
Today, something...
What sprinkles? All right. 612, 12 past 6 o'clock, 92.3 K-Rock, WYSP, WJFK. Yes. Hey, Gary, John, could you bring in some water? Thanks. I'm dragging my ass this morning. What about you?
Me too, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Man. Jesus, it's so hot in here, too.
I know. I'm even uncomfortable this morning.
And I wore a long-sleeve shirt and stuff, thinking, it's going to kind of be cool. And also, figure we're taping a TV show. I want to look sort of handsome, if that's possible. I always think I look better in a long sleeve shirt and with a collar on it.
With a collar?
Yeah. You think so? It makes my neck look a little thicker.
Well, see, I don't analyze you the way you do.
Trust me, don't I look a little more handsome than yesterday today? Come on. You can be honest.
Oh, well, I like the shirt.
Yeah, so. I do. Case closed. What were we talking about in the office this morning, me and you? We had done the whole show already. We had a better show in the office.
Oh, we were talking about Judge Clarence Thomas.
Yeah. We were talking about how, well, Robin really made the observation, at least he goes after black women.
And everybody thinks he turned into, a guy who likes white women.
Yeah.
Look at everybody, he harasses. They're black.
Thank God it was black women, because if it was white women, everyone would say, hey, these white women, they're just trying to set him up, and they're jealous.
That's true.
Yeah, thank God it's black women. There also would have been a whole racial thing. A white woman can't come out against Judge Clarence Thomas. Forget about it.
Well, you know, if that had been the case, he probably wouldn't have had a problem at all.
No, not at all.
He'd have just been dismissed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So the moral of the story is go after white women if you're a black guy. And the thing is, I'm still not even clear what it is he did that, he was in a room. And
he tried to get a couple of dates with her.
She said no.
She said no.
He didn't attack her in any way.
And then so he started describing things he'd see in these porno films to her. At various times.
And did she feel that this was a...
She felt this was... She didn't like it.
Yeah. So did she say, I don't like it?
That it would be jeopardizing her job to say anything. That constitutes harassment.
Wow. Boy. Unbelievable. Unreal.
What do you mean, unreal?
Because it just sets a whole thing up where there's a lot of people, men and women, who sort of don't read signals properly. And every minute they think they're getting harassed. You dig? So anybody who gets in any kind of position, it's harassment. You know what I mean? It's just like, it's a real fine line there between harassment, physical abuse, I understand, or physically grabbing someone.
Well, let me say this about that.
Don't say anything because I'm going to pass out. Okay. I don't want to miss it.
Wait, it's so friggin'
hot in here.
It must be hot in here because, this studio is comfortable.
Yeah, right.
When this studio is comfortable, it's burning up in there.
Hey, Scott, you know anything about the temperature? Is it that the air conditioning is now shut off? There's a point when it starts getting hot for the summer that the air conditioning isn't on yet in the building. And then they turn it off when the cold weather sort of hits.
So, right, I think...
Scott, is there no fresh air coming in?
It's working. Maybe the temperature's up.
You think it's working? Do you have air conditioning back by you? Do you have cold air?
Did you just turn it down?
I didn't do anything. That's where it's been.
So it's already down?
Yeah.
All right, I'll call him.
Oh, boy.
I was expecting Allison Steele to be laying flat on the floor when I came in.
No wonder she sounded a little sleepy. She was going, come, fly with me.
Fly with me. I have not even seen Allison in months.
Really?
Yeah, I got to
see her pregnant every morning.
Yeah, I got to stop in and say hello to her.
That was Allison hitting the deck from the heat.
A lot of commotion back there. Little dog impression.
But let me continue with this sexual harassment thing.
Yeah.
The whole problem is, as soon as someone says to you, hey, I'd like to go out with you.
Yeah.
And you say no.
Right.
That already sets up a situation where you know that person is interested in you sexually, and you have now rebuffed them.
Well, then you're writing the rules down in hard, cold ink, because I'm going to tell you something.
No, I'm just saying, for him to now sit around and start describing rape scenes to her, and bestiality scenes,
yeah,
and orgies, what was that all about? What was he doing that for?
Why? Is that what he did?
Yeah.
Or what if I describe a scene in a movie that I saw, a Goldie Hawn movie, where she's nude, and I thought, God, Goldie Hawn is so attractive. She was naked laying there on the bed. Do you think I'm sexually harassing you?
No, that has nothing to do with...
You don't think so? So I'm sitting in a room with you. I say, you know what I do? I watch a lot of porno. Oh, really?
No. It was not only describing them, but saying, what do you think of that? Do you like that? Would you like that to happen to you?
Oh, really?
That kind of thing.
Well, that I like. You know, it's really weird, too, you know, when you talk about this dating thing where you say, hey, I ask you out for a date, right?
Uh-huh.
You know, some women play hard to get.
Well, you ask a couple of times, fine.
There's been movies written about guys wooing women. Half of the romance movies that we see, whether it be Michael J. Fox in, what the hell's the name of that movie? Remember where he played the young...
Secret of My Success.
Secret of My Success, and he's going after the woman, and he keeps after her, and he pursues her, and... And lo and behold, she finally says yes.
But that, you know, there's a difference in asking for a date and then trying to pressure someone into
that is true.
taking a date with you.
I just don't know what happened there. I just have no idea. And I don't know how in a week they're going to decide. It's a weekend. How they're going to decide in a weekend.
Well, you listen to a bunch of testimonies. She tells her story. He tells his. They got this other woman coming along.
Yeah.
Even one of the women who support him.
Yeah.
Who supports him has admitted that he used to talk about pornography to her. So pornography is there.
Well, he's gone. Bring in the next guy. He's gone. Plus, it's black women accusing him. I like that Anita Hill, though. She ain't bad.
Neither is the other woman.
I haven't seen the other woman.
She's on the cover of the Daily News.
You got the Daily News there, Freddie? Or Jackie?
No.
Oh, you don't have to go get it. I just want to take a look.
Here it is. Can you see this?
Sure. You know, she kind of looks like Sarita. Remember Sarita, who was married to Stevie Wonder?
Oh, I don't even know what Sarita looked like.
Neither did Stevie. Thank you for that. All right, so, that's Sarita. Looks like her. Oh, here you go. Thanks, Jack. I didn't mean to make you do any exercise. Mm-mm. I think she's got some Indian in her. Angela Wright, 37. Mm-mm-mm. She's a new girl, huh?
Right.
Second Thomas accuser. There's another girl.
I like that headline. Do you see what Orrin Hatch said, the senator?
She'll have her ass handed to her.
Oh, that sounds interesting.
I think they ought to get rid of him and Thomas. Well, no wonder he wanted to bang her. Look at that.
No, there's nothing wrong in wanting to bang someone.
You're not kidding.
It's what you try to do to make it happen. It might get you in trouble. You also have to realize
that
when you are in a position of power,
mm-hmm.
you have to be more careful.
Robin, not every guy can go on Joan Rivers and get dates.
Excuse me.
Remember that. Sometimes it's hard out there.
Listen here, you.
Sometimes you got to turn a girl on with some pornography, some bestiality stories. I know that turns on most of the girls I've met in my life.
Well, you're a notorious beggar, which I consider harassment.
I just saw a great movie with this dog and a camel and a girl. I got to show it to you.
But if you're the boss...
Yeah, I know. I got the
You put
thing.
Yourself into a position where the person says, now, wait a minute, this is my boss. I can't tell him I don't like something he's doing.
Yeah, right. Well, you know. There it is. And what else were we talking about back there besides something else we were talking about?
Oh, I don't even know, because that was the one thing.
Yeah. It was a pretty good show we were doing back
there. Yeah, it was funny. It was interesting.
Yeah, some interesting observations. But it is kind of good that at least it was black women he was harassing, allegedly. Because, you know, it's good for a black image. You know, people should see that it's blacks going after other blacks.
Yeah, he finds black women beautiful and sexy, and he wants them.
Let's face it. Now you know why he achieved in life, because take a look at him. Boy.
Well, you know, I thought about that, too. I said, you know, this isn't the best-looking guy in the world.
No. So he became this important guy, I think, just to get some trim.
And then, even then, it wasn't easy.
No.
He had these gorgeous lawyers all working for him.
Yeah.
You think he still had to harass
You think as a boss you could get him without having to tell him about porno movies. Life sucks, doesn't it? I think he should be nominated, if you ask me. I mean, not nominated, but...
confirmed?
Yep.
Why?
Just for not chasing white women.
Oh, geez.
Sticking to, you know, the black women. And
well, he's married, ultimately married a white woman.
Well, there you got a point, too.
So, I don't know.
Now, that make it 50-50. I don't know. That's a tough one. I'm on the fence. I could care less what happens to him. I have my own shallow life to worry about. Screw
well,
him.
See, the point is that he will have an effect on your life if he gets confirmed. That's the point.
And it's interesting, a guy who, if he is going around sexually harassing women, isn't it interesting that he's against abortion? Like, sort of like this, another controlling thing he wants with women, you know what I mean? He wants to control their, sort of, their bodies.
But it's very confusing because he really fought hard to keep sexual harassment on the books as a discriminatory act.
Yeah, but isn't that like the Reverend Swaggart coming out against pornography and yet being one of the biggest abusers of pornography?
That's true, too.
It's kind of like, hey, this is my image, but man, oh, man. It's just like these guys, you always say it to me, these guys always want to keep it from the rest of us. All these anti-pornography guys and anti-abortion guys and all this stuff, they want to keep it from the rest of us because we don't know how to handle it, but they do. Yeah. And you know what it is? They don't know how to handle it.
They're totally out of control.
Yeah. It's almost like they want someone to control them. That's why he's so for these sexual harassment laws. That's kind of interesting psychologically, isn't it?
Yeah. You know, I didn't think of that.
You think you'd be like, by the way, I'm the biggest sexual harasser, and therefore, there's nothing wrong with me. I don't want this on the laws. But no, it's just the opposite. It's almost to make up for all the hassle they put people through.
And then they had like 30 women. Did you see that standing around microphones yesterday saying, you know, that he never did anything to them?
Yeah, they didn't look
like,
as...
Give me a break.
Yeah, he can't harass everyone.
Just because he didn't do it to you doesn't mean he doesn't do it.
Well, hey, look, if he doesn't get on the Supreme Court, he could be captain of the St. John's lacrosse team.
Ooh.
What do you think?
Well, they booted out all those guys.
That's
I don't know
true.
If he's going to coach.
Whoops. 624 923 KROQ WYSP WJFK. What are we doing today? Let's see. Go down my list.
But you know, there was another rape at St. John's yesterday.
So really?
They're coming rape you, I think.
Rape University. What is it, Gary?
I forgot to put something on your list, but it's right there.
Is he reading the list too?
Oh, good. No, and so much better. I actually get the stuff on the list now that he's not reading it. I'm less hostile to the list. Every morning, Gary makes me a list. He used to sit there and read it to me with his fingers.
Baba Booey.
Pointing to each thing. It was so annoying when I'm trying to read the paper. But now it's much better. You make the list, and I actually pay attention to it. So yesterday, I'm paying attention to it, and we had this thing with a bit with a little tiny piano, and I went for the piano. He forgot to put the piano in here.
All you had to do was ask.
Well, just the moment passed.
No, it didn't. It did.
Okay.
It passed.
All right, good. No, it didn't. He's on the air.
Yeah, he knows when it passes and when it doesn't.
You go for something that's out there, you go to something else, and it passes. Don't ever say to boss, the moment didn't pass.
Or don't say calm down.
Right. Which you've been very good about.
Oh, please. Somebody said that to you recently and paid dearly for it.
Who's that?
I can't remember, but... executive producer of our TV show.
Yeah, right. He told me to calm down. I said, no, I don't calm down. Don't tell me to calm down.
I cringe.
That's like Niagara Falls.
Yeah, slowly I
step. People tell me to calm down. I go, no, I want to calm down. The only way I can calm down is when you calm me down by doing your jobs. That's how I calm down.
When you get excited, I calm down.
The last time I got really mad at Gary was a couple of days ago. Because he didn't tell me to calm down, but it was sort of like you were telling me to calm down. Do you remember what I'm talking about?
No.
Remember we were sitting in the office, and I was mad at the people who wrote that article in Billboard?
Oh, yeah.
And Gary turns to me and he goes, you know, boss, all I think is she was just trying to say that you're doing, you know, you were flat in Los Angeles, and that your ratings in New York were good, but the rest, you know, I just think she was making reference to Los Angeles, because in the Billboard magazine, they clearly make reference, and it's a false reference. They say that we were flat, our ratings, all over the country, you know, wherever we are.
Yeah.
I blew my stack. I just had my best book in Philly. Just had a great book in New York. In Washington, we just had a great book. You know, for Washington, if you understand the situation.
Mm-hmm.
And Los Angeles, come on, give me a break.
We're just there.
We just got there. Give us a chance to grow a little bit. I don't know anybody who does it in 6 weeks. You know. So I was pretty steamed up about it. I said, Gary, get that girl on the phone. I want to talk to her. Well, I don't know. It's not so bad. You know, you just get too excited. And I just turned to him. I said, look, Gary, you like making a living? I said, then you better get upset, too. Because the way this show is going to grow is if we're on another market, and Billboard is read by a lot of people who don't know how to read the ratings. They just, you know, these are people
who
potentially...
They wait for other people to analyze it for them, and they take that information.
Right. I want to have a national radio show. Some idiot in Utah reads this, that I'm flat. I don't want that Stern show. I don't want to pay money for it.
Who needs the hassles for a flat show?
Right. And I said, don't try to say anything. I said, either you're on the team or you're not. So he called me later that night to tell me he was on the team.
Oh,
I go,
really?
Well, yeah.
I apologized.
Yeah. Because he's out of line. He just, you know, it's some things you do get excited about. You realize that no one else is going to give you a job like I'm giving you. And you say to yourself, hey, my boss is right. I got to get upset about this. Because what if both will succeed?
Is that impersonation as far off to me as Jackie thinks his is to him?
Yes. I don't know.
Or does that actually sound like me?
Thing. No, you got some...
Because I think your impersonation of Jackie actually sounds like him, but
you
I don't
got,
think...
You got,
I got a lot of...
Well, Jackie, you see, people at home don't realize my impression of Jackie does sound like him, except when he hears me doing it, he lowers his voice and talks calmly.
Right, yeah.
But whenever he gets excited, he gets up in this range. I'm like, you know,
well, basically, what the answer to Gary's question is yes.
Yes.
It does sound like that.
Yes.
It does.
Yeah, because you've got your teeth and everything. It's, yeah. You know, you got a lot going on in that mouth. It's exaggerated.
My teeth are a lot. Everyone has teeth.
Everyone's got teeth.
What am I, Becky the mental patient?
Okay. So anyway, then, you know, it was sort of like Gary telling me to calm down. And I'm just sick of guys telling me to calm down.
Yeah.
You know, hey, I'm not going to calm down about it. I get charged up from it. It's my career. It's our success. We had a successful book, and Billboard writes it going on a flat. I'm upset about it. So he hears me grunting and groaning. He tells me to calm down. Because the girl has written basically nice things about me. I go, believe me, they haven't been glowing, Gary. I subscribe to Billboard. I read it every week. Believe me, I'm on top of that. Your casual reading... is not what I'm interested in. I monitor these things. You know why, Gary?
Because you're a winner.
No, not because I'm a winner.
Oh, okay.
It has nothing to do with whether I'm a winner or not. A lot of losers read Billboard every week. The reason I monitor these things is because they directly affect our career. Believe it or not, you're part of my career. Because believe me, the day that I'm out of radio, you're leaving too. Trust me. When's the last time you got an offer for a job in radio?
Well, I'm so entrenched here. People, you know, people
right.
think
even,
I'm...
They assume you're they not available. You're,
I'm like, well, let me help you with that. Gary's very available, okay?
I love that.
It's a little early for the really important people to be listening.
Right. We'll see if we can
really
get something going for you later.
No.
And I know it disturbs Gary, too, because you know, he wants a job offer badly.
I do not. I want to be...
He does. He wants to be able to say, hey, I moved on.
Yeah.
No, I don't want to leave here at all. I'm very happy here.
No, I know you are. So if you're happy here and you want to see this continue... And you want to see us rise in the ratings, what you should say is, man, oh, man, he's right. Look at that. Meanwhile, he never even read the article.
I condemn her.
No, you know what? I think I even brought it in for you.
Yeah, one.
No, I did read the article, Howard.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, no, I read it twice.
And what did you think?
I thought what you said.
Exactly.
You always think what you said.
You should think what I said.
I think what you said.
Trust me, I know what I'm talking about. Repeat after me, Gary.
Yes.
I'm going nowhere.
I'm going nowhere.
I am nowhere.
I am nowhere.
I got here by luck. All right. Very good. All right. Now you learned your lesson for the day. Now you're prepared to go to work. All right. 630 923 K Rock WYSP WJFK. We'll take your phone calls next.
Morning. Classic rock and roll all day.
Yes.
Why, that means we only have to tape 39 more TV shows. Okay.
You know what I keep thinking? Every time they say in the meeting that we have 35 shows, and I'm like, oh, we've only done three.
Yeah, I know.
Or we've only done two.
Yeah. And those went so easy. It's so much fun. The biggest sales event of the year, rain or shine, it's at Pedigree Ski Shop, the big annual tent sale. Unheard of prices. Entire parking lot covered with four huge tents. Imagine that. You pull up four huge tents. Unheard of prices, up to 70% off. Up to 70% off, many below manufacturer's cost. Top of the line stuff, ski equipment, also tennis, golf stuff, fashion and equipment, and rollerblades. It's not just a ski shop. I shouldn't just call it Pedigree Ski Shop. It's a lot more. Phone 914
948-2995 for direction, okay? People come from all over, Westchester, Connecticut, New Jersey, Long Island, and Manhattan. Who wouldn't? Up to 70% off. That's some event. Phone 914-948-2995 for directions. It's fun, and it's only at the White Plains store. K-Rock Band will be there Friday evening at 5:30 p.m. playing music and giving out all kinds of stuff. Pedigree Ski Shop, 355 Mamaroneck Avenue in White Plains, New York. Thank you. 637-923 K-Rock, WYSP, WJFK. I've got that Chuck Woolery song, Naturally Stoned.
So really?
Yeah, we'll be listening to that.
Good.
Chuck Woolery from Love Connection. He used to be a country singer, Robin told us yesterday in the news, so we went out and got the record. We found it.
Good.
And Gary got it from some listener or something. I don't know what happened there.
It was funny because just, I guess it was an old tape I was watching.
Yeah.
No, maybe it was last night's show. Did you see last night's show?
Yeah.
Where that couple really hit it off?
Yeah.
And the girl came out and she was like making out with the guy.
I couldn't believe it. She was really good. This guy, you know, this guy was kind of...
He was okay. She thought he was great.
Okay. I said, boy, oh boy, this guy doesn't know himself. He picked a girl who's way too good looking for him. It's the first time I've seen a really good looking girl on there. And I said, boy, this is going to be a disaster. And she flipped for this guy.
Yeah.
Jesus. I said, man, I'd love to bang that girl.
See, you never tried.
Nope.
And you could have had that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, believe
me. He didn't look any better than you.
Really?
No, he wasn't good looking at all.
Really?
No, he was average.
Wait a second. Analyze that.
Yeah.
He didn't look any better than you. He wasn't good looking at all.
Well, that means that he was uglier than
you. No. I'm not saying he's terribly ugly. I'm saying
he took it the right way.
Average guy.
Do me a favor, Robin. Somehow I got to get Baba Booey off our topics of conversation. Somehow he's suddenly here.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden.
And suddenly he's interpreting your words. No, the interpretations of Baba Booey. You see why this Judge Thomas thing is dangerous? You get a guy like him who misinterprets everything. And then suddenly he's testifying. Go ahead.
What I came in to tell you about, you were saying that the Chuck Woolery record is a country record.
Yes.
It's not a country record. I guess you can call it rock.
Yeah.
It was sort of in that late 60s flower power era.
Sort of like Kenny Rogers before he went country.
Exactly like that.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, oh yeah, guess my condition is in.
Exactly, it's very flowery and hip.
Just dropped in to see what condition my condition is. And then all of a sudden he became a country singer.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me take a few phone calls first.
Oh, well, anyway, I was just about to say about that did you notice Chuck's face? Now that I read that story yesterday where he sometimes is at odds with the lifestyles of some of the people on the show.
Yeah.
Well, this girl comes running out, and she's like all over this guy's neck like a vampire.
I was so jealous.
And Chuck turned his head away. Did you see that?
Yeah. He's a Christian who's been married 3 times. And suddenly he's a good Christian.
Catholic. That's even worse.
Yeah. Because I don't know, I'm a very good Catholic, and some of these love connection couples, they actually talk about kissing. You know, I mean, really, get with it, pal. Who's buying into that?
He couldn't believe it. This girl ran by him, didn't even want to say hello to Chuck, and dived on this guy.
Good Catholics don't get married 3 times.
Yeah,
maybe
they get
twice.
Once.
They have once, but maybe we'll give them twice. 3 times. I don't know if you're a good Catholic. That's a pretty tough definition. All right, New York, Los Angeles, Philly, and Washington. We're going to them all right now. New York, you're on the air.
Good morning, Howard.
Yes, good morning.
Robin, I've written
Welcome to the Jew.
A poem for you. I would like to, it's clean, I would like to say it if I could.
You wrote a poem for Robin?
Yes, a friendship poem.
Is this that same gay guy?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. You're on the air.
Hey, how you doing, you knucklehead? What's wrong with you, you asses? This is your buddy, Howard Stern Vu.
What is he saying?
You're a DJ. Take my seminar. Make fun of other DJs. Degrade women, insult foreigners and homosexuals, and make big money doing it. You know, I'm not always big shot New York DJ. When I first come to this country, I work as a waiter at a country club. I serve this man at dinner. He say, Howard Stern Vu, get your finger out of my food. I say, here's your food. Then I give him the finger.
Hey, it's a song about me.
Yeah. Country club. Remember, don't be a lesbian. You too can be big shot New York DJ. This is Howard Stern.
Oh, giving me a headache. Finally, a song about me, but it gives me a headache.
Yeah, who ever heard of rapping to country music?
Yeah, that's a pretty bad concept. See, now that we are on in Los Angeles, we get a lot of Hollywood out-of-work songwriters calling us.
We've got all these creative people out there working on us.
You know what's great about Hollywood? The best thing about going to Hollywood and actually visiting is seeing all of the losers. You know, we're used to watching television and hearing all the great success stories. Even that guy Rock, he was a criminal and he became this great, you know, he was a murderer, he got out of prison, became an actor, and you hear about people who grew up in the Midwest. And
Henry Winkler slept on somebody's floor and right. Then becomes Fonzie.
And it sounds like real magic.
Yeah.
But the great part about going out to Hollywood is when you see all of the losers out there who actually think they have some talent. That's the best. If you can get into the spirit of it and not get caught up in the horror of it, it's a lot of fun.
Remember those guys who used to be at the health club every morning?
Yep.
Oh,
yeah.
And they were all working, hoping, you know, one day they'll get a part so their body would be in shape.
Yeah, and you knew they never were getting a part. and the women out there, there's a lot of good-looking women who just are sitting there waiting like crabs or lice that go to hair. They're sitting and waiting for some celebrity or producer to
find them.
Oh, it's just so, it's pathetic.
And they've all already done all the work. They've got the breast implants.
Yeah, they've done everything. They've done everything but get a job. We had a limo driver out there, a limo driver from hell, who had to convince us that he had already appeared in 2B movies. And he has regular breakfast meetings and lunch meetings with Bob. He goes, with that comedian, Bob Waite. We go, do you mean Bobcat Goldthwait? Yes. He doesn't even blink and realize the jig is up.
Right.
It's just, yes, Bobcat Goldthwait.
Oh, I see Altavies all the time,
yeah,
and Bobcat Wade.
Yes. And meanwhile, we're saying he's lucky to have a limo job because he was annoying.
And, you know, he was telling us, you know, every morning he'd pick us up and tell us about the audition he had that afternoon.
Yeah, yeah. How to let us know. I said, why can't I get a limo driver who wants to be a limo driver? God bless Ronnie the limo driver. You know what he wants to be? A limo driver. He ain't thrilled with it, but he likes being it. You know, it's enough. It's him. That's it. And he's not out on auditions. And this guy was driving like a maniac with auditions. His one eye is on the road. The other eye is turned behind his head so he can watch us and get him part of the conversation
right.
In case we should mention a celebrity. Then he's sitting and finally he says, I got to come in and watch you do your radio show. So I let him in. And in 2 seconds flat, the guy's over in Jessica Hahn's corner. Propositioning her to be in a movie.
Claiming he's a producer.
Yeah, now he's a producer. Because Jessica Hahn says to me, who is that guy, that really annoying guy? And now this is Jessica Hahn saying a guy's really annoying, okay? Who's that really annoying guy? Kept coming over about a movie. And now Jessica Hahn normally would be pretty excited.
Uh-huh.
She even saw through him. You know, she's not the best judge of character.
The best was the night he took us to see Family Ties,
yeah.
And he climbed into the back with us, you know.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Wait.
So finally, like, Robin kept saying, but you're going to fire this guy and just get a different driver? I go, look, we're out here for the week. Why make any enemies? And you know what? The guy is getting us. And,
where
and
we let's, need to go.
And if we get into his sense of humor, you know, if we see the humor in this, it could be something. So the last night we're there, Robin and I wanted to go watch them tape Family Ties because we wanted to see how they tape these sitcoms because we'd never been in one. So we go in. And we can't even get in because nobody knows us in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
We're not getting any kind of VIP treatment.
Right, they want us to stand in line.
Yeah, we had to stand in line. So I said, I ain't standing in line. Screw this, man. Back in New York, I'm somebody.
And do you know what? You know what happened to us. As soon as we were standing in this line, this woman turned around and said, Howard and Robin, what are you doing in this line?
How come you're on the line? And I was just like, oh. So I had the guy pull a limo up and actually park the limo in the line so that we were in line, but we were in our cars. So the guy gets out of the limo, climbs into the back with us, starts rapping to us about how he knows Gary David Goldberg, or whatever the guy's name was, who's the producer. And he knows all these guys. And he's very surprised that we have to wait in line. And I mean, I was just like,
you guys should have asked me.
No, it was frightening. It was just frightening.
Hysterical.
I see somebody's on hold. I bet she's Jessica Hahn. Every time I mention her name, she calls in.
Well, she didn't call in when we said she's going to be on Married with Children. Maybe that's this weekend.
Oh, okay. She's got to realize she's got to have something to say. I told her, don't call back until you get sleep with somebody famous. So, I don't know. It was just real weird.
Yeah, but that's the whole the Los Angeles scene.
The guy was not interested in being a limo driver. And he's sitting in the back with me.
Yeah.
I'm going, wait a second. I'm paying and this guy's sitting in the back. Maybe I should get up front.
He asked us to move over.
Yeah.
Hey, move over.
Move over.
So I can get in here.
Oh, and you know, it's like... I don't want to be bothered. We parked the limo right in the line. It was great. And they couldn't understand who we were. We were trying to explain who we were.
Yeah,
That we were very important people.
That's never a good position to be in.
No, we're always in that position. It's just like we pick, you know, that's why I won't go out to California until we get some ratings. I won't go out there to win number one.
Yeah.
Because I, you know.
Can't take that anymore.
I am not standing in the family ties line. I'm just not. It's the end of it. You're on the air.
Oh, Howard, how you doing this morning?
Okay, man.
A little while ago, right? Not a little while ago, when I was like 13.
Yeah.
I was down in Washington, D.C., where I was nearly molested by a man.
Is this Tom Arnold?
No.
Hey, here's the guy. You know, everyone's kind of coming out with these molestations. Are you being serious?
No, I'm being very serious with you.
What happened?
I mean, I can go through the whole shtick. I've been listening to you for 5 years, you know.
What happened to you?
Well, I was in a swimming pool when I was 13. Parents were out sightseeing.
What were you wearing? A little bathing suit?
Yeah, well, I guess I was. I guess when I was 13,
are you a cute guy?
Wearing a little bathing suit. No, he was like a bald guy.
No, you.
What about you?
Me?
Mm. Had you had any hair on your body at this point?
I'm not really sure.
Right, go ahead. So you're in the pool, yeah.
And I'm swimming around, and this guy comes up to me, and he says, "Want to come up to my room?" I'm like, "No, not really." He said,
"What do you say?"
"Want to come up to my room?"
Oh, yeah.
So I said, "Not really."
Yeah.
He goes, "Come on, I have games."
This guy, you know, this guy wasn't even creative. Those are like the classic things they tell you to look for. You tell your kids, "Hey, if someone says, you know."
Games. He said, "You remember that game a long time ago called Merlin?"
Yeah.
He was like, I have Merlin. Looking back at me.
Why'd you say so? Hey, you're a perfect stranger, no problem. Yeah, so he tells you, "Hey, okay, yeah, you got Merlin." So you say no.
That's right.
Yeah.
So I get out of the pool.
Yeah.
And in the pool, there was like a hot tub. I forget what, jacuzzi. So I jump in the jacuzzi. Next thing I know, Jaws jumps out of the water into the jacuzzi next to me.
Oh, boy.
Says, "Why won't you come up to my room with me?"
Sounds like George Thomas.
So he said, "Look, I don't want to. Now leave me alone." I started to get real angry at this point because I knew something wasn't right with this guy. I mean, you had to see this guy. He was like real skinny. Looked like a school teacher.
Yeah. So then what happened?
So then I went into the sauna.
Well, you're...
I don't know.
I think you're asking
for it.
I would have reported this, but go ahead, yeah.
And then in the sauna, he comes in and he says, "You know, why won't you come up to my room with me?" And I'm like, kind of scared, but kind of...
See, because maybe I'm not a homo.
I'm exactly.
But you couldn't say that because you're polite.
Yeah, you're too nice. Like us with the guy in the limo. Hey, get the hell out of our limo. Get up front and drive. Okay, yeah,
then,
so...
So then I get up and I go, "What is that thing on the wall over there?" You know, because that's where the door was. And then he gets up, comes after me, and then grabs my schween.
Whoa.
Yeah?
He grabbed your schween in the
sauna?
Room? Yeah, that was a bad idea, being alone in a sauna with him.
And then,
he grabbed your schween over your,
Over my bathing suit, yeah.
Yeah.
And then I was kind of, like, in shock. And then I, like, punched him in his face and ran out.
Oh, cool.
And then...
You should have killed him.
Then I should have pushed him on the coals in the sauna.
Yeah, you should have. You should have branded him.
Yeah.
Make him sit on that.
Yep. With his schween. Yeah, so he grabs your schween, you run out, you punch him, and you run out, and that was it?
No, then the lifeguard came.
the lifeguard. Hey, I'm supposed to watch the pool, not the sauna. Go ahead, yeah.
Called the police. Police came. Turned out the guy had a record from before.
Wow.
And
cool.
I'd go to Washington like 2 weeks later, and we went to court. He didn't get any jail time, but he got, like, a hefty fine and 10 years probation.
You're kidding. He didn't go to jail?
No, he didn't.
They always let these people off.
And you know what the lawyer was asking me that I always remember?
If you would marry him.
The lawyer always says to me, "How did he grab your schween?"
Yeah.
You know?
Did you have to show
him? Oh, there's a nice
way. He wanted me to show him on the stand.
Did you show?
Well, yeah, with the microphone. I said, like this. I twisted the microphone.
That's what that microphone's there for. That's really a dead mic. It's just in case you got your schween grabbed, so you have something to demonstrate.
That's exactly right.
Honor, I'll call this Exhibit A. Amazing, like my schween, except about 9 inches smaller.
But is there a way to grab a person's schween that's not like...
Say that word again, Robin?
Schween.
Yeah, there you go.
Jewish word.
That is not necessarily inappropriate?
You know, I was thinking back. I've been sexually molested.
Oh,
I'm being serious.
Again.
And I, but you know
now
what it is?
Now you're having flashbacks.
See what it, I mean, it's not a flashback. It's something I knew about the whole time, but I would never consider it sexual molestation until, now everybody's coming out with their sexual molestation story.
Tell us your story, Howard.
A family member.
Really?
Yeah. I'm being dead honest here. When I was about, my sister probably remembers this too. I was about 9 or 10.
Uh-huh.
And I would sit down on this guy's lap. It was a guy. And he would take his hand and grab my schween and my scrot.
Uh-huh.
And dig his hand. But just kidding, it wasn't a sexual thing. Schween. Yeah, I would, Your Honor.
How do you know it wasn't a sexual thing?
I just... at least I didn't perceive. He was in front of my sister and another and someone else, and he would just he'd say, come on, sit on my lap. I'd sit on his lap, and then all of a sudden he would dig his hand underneath my, I could say this for because it's important that people learn about this stuff, testicles, and he would. I shouldn't even use those kind of words. This is a family show. My log and my grapes under my grapes and my log, and he would like dig his hand in and go like that.
Yeah, squeezes a open and close his
hand. Yeah.
Like scratching you, or?
Yeah, almost like, digging in.
Yeah?
I think it retarded the size of my log. I'm being serious to this
That's
day.
That's what he was trying to do.
I'm being serious to this day.
How often did you see this man?
All the time. It wasn't a man, he was another kid. But he did it
another
only,
kid? Yeah, how old was he?
About, I don't know, a couple of years older than me.
Wait a minute.
Hey, ease up, pal. You don't have to cry.
Well, it brings back bad memories.
Were 9, and he was what?
Yeah, but
18?
I was 13, Robin.
But then you get over it.
Oh, yeah, I just hate homos now.
Oh,
you don't
no.
have to hate homos.
No, I just
grab your grapes and log.
Yeah, it's true. This guy was kind of sick.
Yeah.
But what I'm asking, Howard, put it in perspective. This was another kid.
Yeah.
And every time he said, come sit on my lap.
No, it only happened twice, and then that was it.
Oh, because I was going to say, what were you doing sitting on his lap when you knew that was going to happen?
It was very trusting. Well, of course I didn't know it was going to happen.
Well, you've just said every
the second time.
Time.
The second time it happened, he just went, no, it's not going to, I'm not doing that.
And why do you say it wasn't sexual?
I'm just thinking, I'm just trying to hope that it wasn't.
It was sexual for him?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so. You just had to be there.
Why would you grab someone there?
I don't know. I don't have the answer.
Do you grab, when you're in your hijinks with the guys, do you grab them?
Never.
Why wouldn't you grab them? Because if you did.
I was sexually molested.
Yes.
Wow.
See
what I mean? Who would even think to say that's sexual molestation?
I was able to parlay a television show out of it.
Sally's looking for you.
I'm going to Sally, Jesse, Raphael.
The two of you.
Yeah,
I was
sexually molested at 9.
They don't pay their guests.
That's right. I'm a victim of that.
They don't pay their guests.
You could have hugged Roseanne.
Yeah. That big fat blob. I'd rather have a guy grab my grapes and log than have Roseanne, I'll tell you that.
Good God, she's disgusting.
Oh, isn't she?
I mean,
hey, how's your schween nowadays, all right?
Now it's doing fine.
All right, man.
And it didn't it didn't grow up retarded.
Good for you.
In fact, it grew up kind of obese.
Obese?
Yeah, kind of too big.
All right, well, you're very lucky. Maybe it helped.
Maybe that's why the guy grabbed you.
Well, thank you for sharing
I want to ask you a question.
Oh.
All right.
I was just about to wrap up with you.
Well, you can wrap up, but I want to know what the hell this stupid movie that's being advertised for. The Taking of Beverly Hills, who cares?
I know nothing about it. Thank you.
All right, you have a good day.
Thank you for sharing your story.
Sure.
Yes, bye. There he is. Someone who wanted to confess his sexual molestation. And you know
anybody who wants to talk can.
And it's a lot better when girls do it, if we could just say that. I know, it just seems...
Well, look, that man helped you. You realize now that you were molested.
Yes, I realized it like 2 nights ago after all this Roseanne stuff. Yeah, I said, hey,
See, then Roseanne has helped you.
But that's what I'm saying. I mean, Roseanne's carrying it a bit too far. Just relax, honey.
But if she didn't come out, you would never have thought of it.
All right.
Maybe there's some people who don't know the exact definition.
Robin, I got my life to go on with. I'm not Roseanne. I ain't living in the past.
Well, there are children out there, Howard.
Yes, I know.
Who might need to know.
I just don't know how Roseanne remembers at 6 months of age. I don't remember anything at 6 months of age. Do you? And
no,
you've got a pretty good memory.
No. I don't remember anything until about the age of 2.5, 3, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe.
What about you? Where's your earliest memory?
Well, the only memories I have of childhood are the stuff that my father took on film. You know, like
you're kidding.
8mm. I have no other memories of childhood.
Oh, goodness.
I just don't remember. I don't pay attention to stuff like that. I remember a couple of things about my birthday parties. And you know what? It's because my old man had it on film.
You remember your childhood friends.
Friends, yes.
Then you remember things. You remember things you did.
I remember...
You remember Great Garlou.
Yeah, I remember certain things, but I remember very few things.
But you don't remember your very first memory.
No, I would not have any idea what that is.
Well, your first memory's a little later.
Right. I'm telling you, I have trouble remembering like a month ago. I'm being honest. I just have very short-term memory. Can I tell you?
Well, it's in there, you know.
It's in
there.
You're
repressed.
I don't know
what you're covering up.
Maybe
we need to hypnotize you.
I don't dwell on things.
We should have you hypnotized.
No.
You
don't want
that.
I don't want to dredge it up. I was molested at a very young age. 657-923-K, Rock, WYSP, WJFK. Let me take a short break, get over my molestation, and then...
I'll come and comfort you.
And then we'll play the Chuck Woolery song, Don't Go Away.
All this weekend at 94 WYSP. Of course, morning. Classic rock and roll all day.
As always, price includes installation, delivery, padding, stairs, and guarantee on labor. That's great. Giant carpet. You hear what they give you? Delivery, padding, stairs, and guarantee on labor. By the way, they do have Anso crush resistor. That's a great carpet. 100% nylon fiber, the most durable carpet fiber available. New crush resistor technology. Anso crush resistor. Ask to see Anso crush resistor. Because if you're really worried about how your carpet's going to look a couple of years from now, you should check out Giant Carpet's Anso Crush Resistor Carpet Value. Now, Giant Carpet has a high profit opportunity for a franchise business. If you're interested, call Giant Carpet at 1-800-926-7942 for more information. Giant Carpet. Thank you. All right, 732. Giant Carpet with a lot of messages. Franchise business, sale.
Anso, everything's going over there. They're growing.
Anso Crush Resistor. My head explodes from their commercial. There's so much going on. More going on than in this show. 732-923-K, Rock, WYSP, WJFK. I'm very anxious to hear the Chuck Woolery song. So
yeah, so am I.
Let me do that, and then we'll get to your Dial-A-Date, and we'll get to news and everything else. Yes, Robin will be on Dial-A-Date today. That is who I'm offering up. Robin. Let's remember what the advantages are to dating Robin.
What are they?
Okay, I'll go through them. A, giant breasts that have been fixed to the perfection. They're not only full, but they're firm.
And you're attracting the wrong crowd already.
I know. But come on, hey, you've got to sell some of your physical attributes as well. She has reduced her size. She has neutralized to the point where she wears clingy, stretchy clothes. She enjoys a good spanking.
Oh,
well,
wait a minute.
Hey, wait a second. You got turned on by it. Hey, did I mention her breasts? I mentioned that already, right?
Yeah. Yes, you did.
Okay. A salary that would put most of you guys to shame.
I'm looking for an equivalent.
I see.
Not somebody who...
Well, who are you going to find?
Me.
I mean, this woman makes money. She's got more apartments than Donald Trump. She enjoys bathing. Smells like that friggin' potpourri in her panties. I'm selling you, Robin. I know it's a little embarrassing, but I got to sell you in the proper light.
Oh, boy.
Attract the right kind of man. Upscale. And not only that, let's face it.
What?
Probably if you get tight with her, you get to hang around with cool guys.
Like?
Like me, Fred, and Jackie.
Oh.
Not Gary. By the way, she has really long nails. Very elegant. Enjoys a vibrator. Soft tongue. I know that.
Soft tongue?
You have a very soft tongue.
Where do you know my tongue from?
Her teeth don't get in the way. She has nice teeth. Good looking. Good body. Her tongue darts back and forth in her mouth very fast. If you know what I'm saying, guys.
Amazing.
And if you want, you can even write articles to soap opera magazines.
Oh, you.
And her feet smell good, too. Because I've had your shoes off a couple of times.
Right. To tickle my feet.
Right.
Which aren't ticklish anymore. You could do that anytime.
There's no stinky odor to them. But you do enjoy spanking.
I did.
A throttling
say
when
that.
You've been bad.
I did not say that.
When you tease.
No.
She's got a nice apartment. Real nice.
Not that they're going to see it.
No? You like them? Yeah. Hey, look at, you know, whoever thought Fred Norris's date was going to see his apartment? I don't even know that she's seen his apartment.
She blindfolded.
Right.
She still doesn't know where they live.
And by the way, if she really hits it off, she'll take you home to meet her family. That's if you act quickly, because that's subject to change.
Hey, listen to you.
On any given day.
Right. I've surprised you so far, haven't I?
That's true. How's the barometer in there?
But I have surprised you so far, haven't I?
Well, that's a big dial.
Don't you realize that my father's birthday was this past Saturday?
Did you send a gift?
I sent a gift.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. Boy, you are a new woman. You have changed.
See there? You said I hadn't. You said this was just a phase.
Well, it could be.
How long does a phase last?
A phase?
Yes.
A phase can go as long as a year.
Okay.
Hey, even remember when I was working out with weights? That went 4 years. Boy, that phase went quick. I even bought home equipment.
It's not quite the same thing.
Mm. What was the gift to your father? Let me guess. Your right phone number.
No, I'd already given them that.
What else can I say about you in terms of sexuality as a woman, as opposed to the professional that I know?
I'm a very warm, intelligent, bright, humorous.
You howl like a hyena in bed. You said you made a lot of noise in bed. For guys doing you just the right way. And you enjoy vibrator. That turns me on. What about sex that doesn't make babies? Do you enjoy that? Do you enjoy that? Is that one of your qualifications?
I don't think that that's something I'm disclosing.
Is your gyro as muscular as Jessica Hahn's? I would guess it is. That's my guess.
Oh, dear.
Well, everyone knows you. Listen, everyone knows you already.
Thank you. I hope they didn't listen to this mess.
I know a few guys who are already calling in. I know of a
Neil's
few.
On the phone.
Neil's on the phone. Disguising his voice.
I work for Drink Brothers. I live with my mother-in-law. But that's no problem. I can stay over your house anytime. I own a car. Albeit I get a lot of accidents, but I own a car.
Yeah, I still manage to keep a car.
I always keep a car. I have a computer, but I can't type. So I just get very little use.
I have several computers.
Several computers for no apparent reason. And I have a phone that I can talk to.
And I have a satellite dish on my house.
Yeah.
It looks like it's going to topple the house.
And the house is smaller than the satellite dish. And when we go on the subway, I can walk under the turnstile.
Well, you are going to probably be very discriminating, aren't you?
I would say so,
All right. All right, but don't be too tough on the guys. Come on, you
too
know, good
tough?
Man.
What is too tough?
Well, we'll see. We're about to find out, aren't we? But don't you want to hear the Chuck Woolery song?
Yes.
Let me take a break, play the Chuck Woolery song, and then we'll come back and get into your screening process
for
your dates right after these words.
I want to tell you about the men's values at NBO. But first, I want to talk about this new men's movement that has you question your values as a man by holding hands in a circle and howling, or by hugging a tree while you're naked. Now, I'm all for a man questioning his values, but I think if you want to do it, then a great way is to put your values up against the men's values at NBO. And the place for that is this weekend at the NBO.
Classic rock and roll all day.
There's real brewed iced tea, regular in diet, cranberry and raspberry iced tea, orange and unsweetened. Snapple is proud to announce the introduction of an all-natural, no-caffeine iced tea. I could talk about the stone blue in the face. You got to taste it. Snapple. Snapple standard size 16-ounce bottle. You get more for your money, 33% more than their imitator standard size bottle. Anything you see with the Snapple label is natural. Thank you. All right. 746, 923K, Rock, WYSP, WJFK. Jackie's going to be at Governor's Comedy Shop Halloween night, Robin. You were asking.
Oh, because I know I need to be wherever Jackie is.
Thursday, October 31st. It's in Levittown, Long Island. Free album with admission, jokes, and information. Dial 516-922-WINE. And his 13 Wild Party cassettes available at All Tower Records and Sam Goody's on both coasts. It's Jackie Joko Martling. Gary, I don't want to talk about your pictures anymore.
Why? Because I may be right?
Well, we'll do it later. It's just I got a lot to get to. Robin's going on dial a date, which is
yeah, we have to vindicate you right away.
I won't have that guy later, but I'm sure that's what makes it funny.
Yeah.
What guy?
What, Mark Chernoff?
Right.
Mark Chernoff has no credibility. Isn't he the same guy who said Flo and Eddie can't miss in New York?
There's a difference between...
They missed.
There's a difference
no credibility
between,
whatsoever.
But there's a difference between judgment and reality.
All right, good. Just explain it to me later. Oh, my back.
Oh, your back hurts?
Chair's uncomfortable. Oh. Anyway, where was I?
He just really wants that onus off of his good name.
I'll tell you something. Where I move, it's so weird. It's like my wife went to one of those school board meeting things.
Again?
Something like that.
Again she's getting involved?
I moved to a community where the schools are good and stuff. And I figured, I'll move to a good community where there's good schools. And they're always taking these votes on the budget. And they ship in these old people by bus.
You mean they have local elections?
Oh, yeah, like local bond issues, yeah.
Wow, I didn't know that.
All the time. And you know what? These old people, I can't... This is why
Where do they come from?
This is why
don't
I hate old people.
Do they have an address?
Yeah, they do. They're from the community, but like they would never come out and vote unless you got them on a bus and bust them in to the polling place.
And who's doing the busing?
I guess some old guy or people who don't want to pay any more taxes. They don't want to contribute anymore to the school system.
Mm. I understand now that this is a problem everywhere.
Well, there's a whole big thing.
Retirement community.
Yeah. Well, but it's also, it goes deeper than that. The teachers in the community now. My wife went to a big meeting.
Mm-hmm.
So it was the teachers and everyone. The teachers are like threatening to go on strike or something because they want more money.
Yeah.
So they had this big meeting and the school system basically said, hey, times are tough. There's no more money.
And?
And the teacher said, okay, we accept that. There's no more money. So why don't you pay us what you're paying for the year, and next year, if things get better, you can give us more money. So the guy, you see, the guys in the school system, I was kind of going along with the guys in the school system.
Yeah, because that sounds reasonable.
But the guys in the school system said, no, 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 we want you to sign like a 3-year deal or something. So they're saying, well, why should we do that? What if things get better?
And we're locked in at this low
rate. It sounds like you're not on our team. You're trying to sort of lock us out of more money. This is the way my wife describes it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, I'm with the teachers on this then. Because, but I don't know, it seems like the whole community doesn't care or something. Or maybe they do. Maybe
I don't know, there's a change, really a big change in attitude in this country about children. We of the me generation.
Very selfish.
Yeah,
yeah, but
we don't
meanwhile,
care.
It's the people who aren't of the me generation who are coming in on the busload and voting because they already put their kids through the school and enjoyed the school system.
Yeah.
Now they've decided they shouldn't pay any more taxes and they shouldn't
but
contribute
to anybody
else's kids.
But what are they thinking about?
Me. Yeah, but I'm saying they're like our parents' age.
Yeah, but they raised us. So we had to get this from somewhere.
Yeah, well, you know what I mean. It just really sucks.
But, I even hear people of our age say, I just can't afford any more taxes.
Yeah. Well, listen,
it doesn't even matter what they're for.
They're right. We're being taxed to death on the wrong things.
But that's what I'm saying. If they say now, all right, so we got all these bogus taxes everywhere else. But if they come to you and they say, now we have to have a bond issue just for education.
Yeah.
Well, I can't pay anymore.
Right, yeah. And it's real weird. So that's going on. And it's like, I don't even want to hear about it anymore. I'm just like, why should this be an issue? But, I don't know. I'm going to have to start investigating. I might actually have to show up at one of these meetings.
Uh-oh.
And get involved.
Well, that ought to get them into shape.
Yeah. Yeah, I might actually show up. I want to hear for myself what's going on. Take me 5 minutes to cut through the crap. Too many yentas showing up at these meetings.
No, I'll tell you, just having lived in a condo once, it's impossible to live with people.
You can't get
it's
anything done.
It's impossible to live with other people.
And that's why you're so attractive as a dial-a-day problem. All right, 7:50. Try to say you like living with people.
I love people.
That's it. I'm trying to get you a better class of man.
It's so wonderful.
10 in front of 8 o'clock, 92.3 K-Rock, WYSP, WJFK. Just quickly here. I got to hear what Chuck Woolery was doing.
Was doing when Merv Griffin spotted him.
Merv Griffin saw him on the... Now, Chuck was on the Tonight Show as a recording artist.
Right. He was on the Tonight Show to perform this song.
And then Merv spotted him.
Yeah.
Well, he's good.
His eyes lit up, yes.
Ooh. Is that what it said? His eyes lit up?
Well, it says that Merv pegged him for a game show host right away.
Funny, I wonder if Merv's ever seen me on TV. So this is the song Chuck Woolery supposedly had a hit with.
Yeah. Did you know it? Have you heard it?
No, Naturally Stoned. I haven't listened to it yet. The band was called Avant Garde. Chuck Woolery. Excellent.
Oh, yes.
Sounds like Secret Agent Man. Right?
Yeah. Since the days we spent together all too quickly fade away. I know this song.
Is that Chuck Woolery singing?
Yeah.
It is?
He was supposed to be the singer.
Huh. Now my lonely mind is. You know this song?
I vaguely remember this. They say grow up, put your
mind on what you have to do. Yeah, girl. But I know I can never make it, baby, without you. Wow, he's sexy.
See, now he's showing his watch.
Yeah, that, 2 and 2.
No, I don't know this song.
Believe me, you don't know it.
Oh, dear. This is almost a letter.
Yeah, he's naturally stoned. He's high on life. In other words, this is, I guess it's Chuck's anti-drug song.
Yeah, against all the psychedelics.
I'm naturally stoned. Pretty heavy lyrics. I wonder if he wrote them.
Well, he even admits that his talents as a musician were pretty mediocre.
Yeah, I'll go with it. I'll go with him on that. His talents might be as bad as mine. And now they say it's time for me to face their troubled world alone. Right. So that might turn him to drugs. But I know I can never do it while I'm standing on my own. There's just one thing that they do not seem to understand. Why can't they get it through their heads? I need a helping hand. Yeah, Sally Berber. I can get a good vibration when I put my mind on you. I get a real sensation, feel like I'm naturally stoned. Naturally Fifth dimension.
Oh,
now, some. Now let's hear the break. Oh, there's no break. Wow. Naturally stoned. Wow.
Wow.
Supposed to be a, kind of like a psychedelic break in there, but.
No, they didn't have room for psychedelics. Love that that string section.
Yeah, that was nice. Nice touch. What's that other song you had? Ride My Face? Boy,
you know
is he lucky Merv spotted him?
Yeah. What I don't understand is says he goes to church every week. Now, I thought in the Catholic Church that if you got a divorce...
You were excommunicated?
Yeah.
Nah, it's only if you're a big celebrity and then they let you back in. Church has a whole bunch of laws to get over the real laws that they have. You know what I mean? To put up with the people we have in society today.
See.
What are you going to do? Keep Chuck Woolery out? You're going to excommunicate a Chuck Woolery?
A good Catholic like that?
It is true that you got divorced, but if we drop lamb's blood on you... Then you are annulled. You know, there's always some thing.
Yeah, he probably got two annulments, which would make his children illegitimate.
It's almost like, religion is like obsessive compulsives. If I touch the door three times, then I'll be okay.
Light five candles.
Yeah, and that's what the Catholic Church or the Jewish temple or any of them are like.
Yeah.
If you got enough dough or you got enough prominence, you can sort of get yourself back in good grace. Yeah, the guy's in the mafia, but, you know, hey, he did light three candles. And so he was divorced two times. But he can't understand something. He's in the eyes of the church, it's an annulment.
Ah.
Even though you were married 7 years and had three kids.
And your kids are all
right,
there.
Right. You know.
What are they?
Kneel down, eat a wafer, fart against the wind three times, and get out of here. All right, you're back in the church. Now make a donation. All right? We got to be serious. If they actually made people behave like good Catholics, there'd only be three people left in the Catholic
That's
church.
That's true. Nobody could stay.
Right. Who would be able to stay? Priests themselves are busy fornicating. I mean, no one can stay in. You've got to have
but
a little...
But don't you see there's something inherently wrong with an organization that has rules that nobody can abide by?
Yeah, well, they can abide by them as long as you make amendments to the rules.
But no, I'm just saying every time you turn around, there's an amendment and another amendment.
Yes.
And if you come in and confess all your sins, then we'll start all over again this week and you'll come in and mess up again.
Well, that's what's wrong with gays trying to join the church. I've said this many times on the air. Don't try and join an organization that at the basis of the religion says you're evil.
Yeah.
Don't even bother with them. Make up your own stupid religion that says heterosexuals are evil. All right, 7:56. We got to take a break, and then let's begin the screening process for Robin's dial-a-date.
Uh-oh.
Wow. What a surprise this was this morning. She came in, I want to be on dial-a-date. I said, well, you don't have to push me. Do it right now.
I thought you were going to fight me on it.
No, not at all. The 1-800-544-8669. 1-800-544-8669. Now open in Brooklyn. The Leather Warehouse. Warehouse prices and selection, designer quality and style. The Leather Warehouse. Thank you. 802 WXRK New York, WYSP, WJFK. Why don't we go to the phones and see what's on there for you, Robin?
All right. I can bail out at any time, right?
Nope. You got to be committed to it.
We don't have good prospects.
There's got to be some good guys in New York. The phones have been lit up now. Now, let me ask you this. Are you only entertaining guys from New York or everywhere?
Everywhere.
Philly, Los Angeles, Washington. Are you opening this up? would be hard for you to date a guy from Los Angeles.
Yeah, right? Don't I have enough restrictions on my time already?
Yeah, but what if it's like a Hollywood guy, you know? You know, you're looking for a certain kind of guy.
Hmm.
Well, we'll see. See what's going on here. Andy will fly them in for the date.
Hello?
Andy's always flying people in.
You're on the air.
Hey, it's Nick.
Nick?
Yeah.
You want to date Robin?
Yeah.
This is the first. I mean, how long have we been on the air in New York? 8 years? 9 years?
Something like that.
I've never heard you agree to a dial a date, ever. You said, absolutely not. I'm not dating anyone in the audience.
Well, Nick, do you listen to this show?
Yeah, all the time.
You're disqualified. No.
You would like Robin?
Sure.
What do you do, Nick?
I'm a box maker.
Oh, that's bad. Hey, the guy makes boxes, Robin. You don't have a lot to talk
and
about.
I'm sure he makes fine boxes.
Well, what are you saying? By laughing, are you saying that a guy has to be a doctor?
Well, Howard, what are we going to talk about? You know I'm one of those people who needs someone who's intellectually stimulating.
Like Neil. Look.
Neil is my charity case. I've already got one.
All right. Now, what kind of boxes? Square or rectangular? Maybe that'll influence.
All kinds, I'll bet.
All kind of boxes?
All kinds.
All right. Get with it, will you? You're on the air.
Now, what kind of boxes?
See, girl, here's a box maker. Right? But meanwhile, the guy could be a multimillionaire box maker. Right away, that's not glamorous enough. That's the problem with women.
Nothing, no, now you're jumping to conclusions. It has nothing to do with...
The guy said his name is Nick, and he's a box maker, and you started laughing. You're on the air.
Howard, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good, man.
All right.
My name's Jerry, living in New Jersey.
Now, Jerry, Robin's a very special girl. I mean, to get a date with her, I mean, the media attention will be... Well, first of all, can you handle that?
Well, currently I am unemployed, but I am putting together a recording studio. And
all right, I know what you're looking for. All right, hi, you're on the air.
Hello, Howard.
Even if he put together the recording studio, he'd still be unemployed.
Yeah, he can't afford tape for it.
All right. This is where meat and media... join. You're on the air.
How you doing?
All right.
Hey, Robin.
Hello.
All right, what do you do? Let's get right to it.
What do I do? I work for a telecommunications.
All right, you make a lot of money?
Medium.
What is medium?
40? 40,000. I just got out of the Navy, so I landed a pretty good job.
You're on the air. I know you're looking. See, I know you. I know exactly what you're looking for, some guy to take care of you.
No, I don't need to be taken care of. I just don't want to take care of anyone else.
All right, you're on the air. She's already dated in the 40,000 price range. Well, you see, all of a sudden she's a big shot. Everything with money. You're on the air.
No.
Howard, how you doing?
It's just the guy just got out of the military. I would like to see him.
I don't like military men. I'll tell you the truth. I was there, okay? I know.
Robin was
that.
In the service. You're on the air.
How you doing, Howard?
All right.
Robin.
What do you do?
I'm a field engineer.
Field engineer. Now, that's something interesting.
Now, what is that?
Data communications. I don't make a lot of money either, but I...
See, Robin, I want to just say something on behalf of all these men that are calling in. And now I'm going to hang up on this guy. You know.
Wait a minute.
All right, just one second. I think the problem is you meet guys like this soap opera guy.
No. What are you talking about?
Because that's a friendship. You're looking for some romance. Are you getting romance from him or not? Do you check with him? Is it okay for you to be on dial a date?
I don't check with anyone. I'm in my own life.
Oh, boy. Have a good date. All right, so... You know what I mean. You meet a lot of these. We meet a lot of high-profile people.
Yes.
And if you're, you know, I want you to consider these regular guys. Because I think you'd be happy with a regular guy.
I would not be opposed to a regular guy.
A regular guy who makes, what, $300,000 to $400,000 a year?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, yes, you're on the air. Now, what is it before I hang up on you?
How you doing? I'm a great,
You're on the
great,
air.
What?
You're a great nothing. She doesn't want to talk to you. It's ridiculous. You're on the air. No guy is good enough for you. Wait, you'll see.
Stop it.
You'll see. You will never stop me and say that guy's good enough for me.
All right, come on.
You're like a princess.
I know they're out there.
You got to just be realistic. There are regular guys.
What are realistic?
You know what? I'm going to tell you what's realistic.
I'll tell you.
No, don't tell me something.
Yeah.
You've already spoken enough. You already told us what you want in a guy. You are like so many women that I know out there, the enters on Long Island.
Here we go. I knew he was going to put me in this category.
Who think that they're unbelievable. They have good self-opinion. But at the same point, every guy, there's something wrong.
No. The guy has to have a good opinion of himself, too.
All right. Let's see. Do me a favor. As I plunk down the phones, you guys just say your salaries. I'll go until I hit
pay
dirt.
That is not true.
All right. Hi. What do you make? Hello?
Have you plunked down the phone?
How much money do you make?
$125,000.
Are you a black man?
No, I'm a white man.
You are a white man.
That's correct.
Well, how do you make that money? Is it legal?
Well, I work for Aerospace Incorporated.
You work for an aerospace, what are you, a rocket scientist?
Well, no, I design and manufacture new airplane parts and, you know.
Now, it sounds like you're from another country.
No. I'm in New York.
But I'll tell
you
one thing.
It is like another country.
If Robin dates you, you give me the creeps. So I don't know. I don't know if I can handle being around the two of you.
Really?
You've got a creepy sound to your voice.
You must lay some engineering terms on us.
Yeah, I just recently woke up. You know, I have no blood circulating in my system, so.
Oh, really? He's a vampire, too.
He's like the guy in Living Color, the guy in prison with the big words. I just recently woke up.
And no blood is circulating in my system.
The guy in prison with the good language.
Right.
It's a weird accent. Now, tell me something. Where did you study aerodynamics?
I went to Nassau Yeld.
Nassau Yeld?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you were at Nassau Yeld.
No. That's in Oklahoma.
Yes.
It's a college for engineering for aerodynamic airplanes.
And what are some of the airplanes you've worked on?
Well, actually, I developed a small program for the stealth.
Really?
The stealth bomber, that's correct.
Do you believe this for a second?
I don't know. I it sounds okay to me. How much is 2 and 2?
4.
Now you, see.
I can't compute.
It's just a weird accent and everything.
No, I mean, I just,
Count backwards from 10.
What?
Count backwards from 10.
Count backwards from 10?
Yeah.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
How old are you?
I'm 28.
Wow.
When did you get out of school and start building airplanes?
The stealth bomber.
About 3 years ago.
Really? 3 years ago you got out and you've already designed stuff for the stealth bomber. So you're a genius, aren't you?
Correct. But, you know, enough about me. And I like to talk about Robin a lot. I believe she's, you know, a very luscious woman and I've seen her on TV. And
Robin, are you
know,
interested in this?
No,
don't like this luscious guy. Luscious woman.
Sounds like an engineer.
Well, you know. He's trying. You're not. Before I hang up on you, just admit the truth. You're not.
I mean, I have a fetish for black women, and Robin really fits in my criteria.
Well, that's a wonderful thing.
And you're a black man.
No, I'm not a black man.
You're just not white. I know it.
No, I am white. Believe me.
You sound a little bit like Rocky.
Really?
Rocky as a scientist. Mm-hmm. All right. Listen, is she? Yes. You know what? She don't like you.
No, I can tell.
I'm not too thrilled with you. Well, another discarded American. Very weird guy. He was up to no good, believe me.
A luscious woman.
Luscious woman.
You know.
I don't know. All right, but he did have a rap going. You got to give him that. You're on the air.
Hello. Does she want a date or does she want a husband?
No, I don't want a husband.
All right, now, you asked
a big deal about how much you make and everything like that.
Right.
Because I get tired of these guys whining and being unable to pay the bills and that sort of thing.
She's had some bad experiences.
You know, I do go to a lot of, I'm not going to McDonald's with anybody.
Yeah.
Not that McDonald's isn't wonderful.
She's got a certain lifestyle.
Just ask that.
Let's
okay?
face it. From this show, Robin's got a certain lifestyle, and she's gotten very hoity-toity.
Right. Like he's going.
Yenta to me.
What?
Sounds like a yenta to me.
Well, then you're rejecting me.
Not really.
I don't think this... You know what?
What?
You're never going to choose any of these guys.
Well, you never know who might come on the phone.
Well, who are you waiting for? John Stamos? Luke Perry? I mean, be realistic. These are average guys, all working, hardworking guys, making... Hey, last guy, $125,000.
Yeah, right.
How much do you make?
I make $60,000 a year.
All right, $60,000 a year. What do you do?
I'm an electrician.
You're probably a great guy.
You're an electrician.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's wrong with that?
Nothing. I didn't say anything was wrong with that, Howard.
You don't like that. I know you don't like that. How old are you?
38.
You're not 38.
Mm-hmm.
You bang a lot of gashish?
How old are you?
I hear your wife in the background.
You married?
Mm-hmm.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Enough with you. We would prefer to hear from soap opera stars
Howard.
This kind of guy.
No.
You're on the air. Yes?
Hello?
Yeah, you want to play?
What's that?
Now, you sound like a businessman.
That's exactly what I am.
What do you do?
I work for myself.
All right, what kind of business?
I'm a broker.
Stockbroker. I'm hanging up on you.
What?
I can't stand these brokers.
Oh, he's rejecting you.
Most of them are crooks. Most of them are crooks.
Oh, here you go with most of them are crooks.
Trust me, I know.
All right.
On this one, now I got to step in.
I would have talked to you for a few minutes.
All right, let's see what happens. Are you a crook?
Am I a crook sometimes?
Yeah, I thought so. What is all that radio in the background? Turn that off. You're annoying
me. Guys at work here, they're listening.
I don't care. Goodbye.
See there? He ruined his chance.
Crook.
Crook.
You're on the air.
All right.
This is a stockbroker. I got a great tip for you. Yeah, yeah. You know what? I got a tip, too. Tip of my Johnson. Yes?
Yes. I'm here to play Donald Day.
Well, you sound like an attractive man, are you?
I think so.
Yeah, you got a big schween?
What do you consider big?
Well, what do you consider big?
Big would be like 10 inches. I'm not 10 inches.
What are you?
9.
No. Oh,
I consider that big. Get a lot of girls?
A couple here and there.
Mm-hmm. What do you do?
I'm a telecommunications person.
What does that mean? You climb poles?
No, I don't climb poles.
Sounds like he's got enough of a pole, Robin, that you can climb.
I do video conferencing.
Video
what
conferencing.
Is that?
I know what that is.
Yeah, because I'm telling you, these new terms.
Isn't that where, like, businesses, like, they have a, let's say, one company's in Tokyo, the other one is in America, and they can have a conference through video?
Yeah, yeah, and they can see each other in ways and so
now,
forth.
Now, what do you do in that whole process?
He's a 1-800 operator.
I'm a 1-900 operator. No,
so what do you do to get these people linked up?
I arrange the lines and the rooms and the video equipment.
How much money can you make doing something like that?
Decent amount.
Couldn't be that good. You're working for the phone company.
No, I'm not.
Working for a satellite company?
Nope.
Who are you working for? Some kind
private
of company?
Private industry.
Private
this
industry.
This is your own business.
Are you the president of this company?
No.
Well, how much
it's
money
pretty
do you
new company. I'm number two.
How much money do you make?
About 40.
All right, Rob, I'm going to end this charade right now. Let's skip the dial a day. This guy, a lot of girls would like this guy, but you, this
wait
guy.
Wait a minute, what do you look like?
Did I get a thumbs down?
What's no, I no, never I, said anything. He's doing that.
I know what's
all
going
of
on. She is 40,000.
No,
guy,
that's not
you know, she's
true.
Jaded. She's doing very
true.
Well.
What do you look like?
About 6 foot tall, short, black hair.
And you got a 9-inch schween.
Well, I might be exaggerating a little bit.
Yeah, I thought so.
Do you look like anyone famous? Are you a good-looking guy or what? What's the deal?
He looks like Fred Norris. Nah. Who do you look like?
I don't know.
Girls ever say who you look like?
Well, when I was younger, people used to say I look like Elton John.
Oh, John.
All right, look, I'm going to end the charade right now. All right, thank you.
Okay, take it easy.
All right, that's it. That's the end of dialogue.
Oh, stop
that's
it, Howard. Come on. I will date someone.
Got to look like Sting.
Come on.
Like Elton John's a bad-looking guy. He's pleasant. He got a pleasant face.
Elton?
I'm sure he does.
I mean, you date him.
You have to get him. I just might. 8:15.
I'm sure you
right.
could.
Very good. That was dialogue.
No, it wasn't. Come
yes,
on, one
was.
More time. No,
all right,
one
I'll take
more,
a break. I'll give you one
more
shot.
Chance.
And that's it. Because I'm not going to sit here all day with this. I might even go to the.
You didn't even find any decent people that you would have had play.
Oh, yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
I absolutely did.
Did not. Who?
The first guy
the
who.
The electrical engineer?
The $125,000 guy.
Oh,
the
you.
Aerodynamic guy.
You didn't.
He said
like
you were
him.
Luscious. Guy's attracted to you, makes a lot of money, and he's a very bright guy. He developed a stealth bomber.
Oh, I didn't believe that for a moment.
Well, we'll be back right after this. How much do you get a week?
$1,250.
We're really smart. We can't figure this
times
out.
Times 52. 2 times 0 is 0. 2 times 5 is 10. Carry the 1. 2 times 2 is 4 and 1 is 5. 2. Okay. 5 times 0 is 0. 5 times 5 is 25. Carry the 2. 5 times 2 is 10 and 12. Carry 5, 6. 0, 0, 0. Carry the 1. 5. That's 65,000. That's pretty close.
And then plus extras.
Like?
Like bonuses and so on.
Hmm. So that brings it up to 75.
Yeah.
And how old are you, Nick?
22.
22?
I told you there'd be something
wait,
wrong with that. No, all right, let's
wait,
be
you
honest.
Extremely good looking.
Don't waste our time.
Come on, will you stop?
You don't want a 22-year-old.
Why not?
Oh, you do? Oh, you would go out with a 22-year-old?
Sure I would.
What's wrong with that?
I didn't say anything. I would go out with a 22-year-old.
Why wouldn't I?
I'd marry a 22-year-old. So young and fresh.
You, I don't know. What do you look like?
I'm 5'8".
Yeah.
90, brown hair.
Yeah, you muscular?
A little bit. I work out.
Who do you look like?
Myself.
All right. You got a great personality, too.
I was in the studio once before.
All right, when?
Goodbye. No.
When?
I was in for Nutrisystem about 2 years ago.
Oh,
and we had the same conversation because you said I was boring because I'm a box maker.
Well, Nick,
Well, you tell him, Robin.
We have to move along.
All right, thank you. I told you, no guy is good.
Come on, will you keep looking?
I'm taking three more calls.
Oh, you're not being
fair to me. It's already 8:30, it's news time.
Well, you started late with your Gary investigation.
You're on the air.
Yeah, Howard.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Ash.
Who's Ash?
Well, I'd like
to... That means he's got a nice Ash. Yes, Ash. Ashley, right?
Yeah.
All right, Ashley. Now, what are your qualifications? You make a lot of money?
Well, I'm an airline pilot.
You're a pilot?
Yeah.
Now, this is something that would interest Robin.
Yeah.
Now, that I like for her.
Well, I'm a corporate business pilot.
Okay. What does that mean?
He flies business.
Well, I work for GNC Aerospace.
Robin, let the man talk. Oh, I'm trying to get a feel for him.
All right.
You're already talking for him. You're already trying to change him and get him into shape. He flies a businessman. Yeah, I just say, you know, please. What are you married to him already?
All right, go ahead.
She likes a pilot. I know you. You like this pilot, don't you? You like the idea of it.
At least he's done something with
right,
his life.
Right. Now, what were you in the force and you learned how to fly, or?
Actually, no. I learned how to fly when I was younger. I've been flying since I was 14 years old.
So you must have grown up in a wealthy family.
Yeah.
Now, you see, I've asked him enough that he should be allowed to play.
Go ahead. He can play. Uh-huh. How old are you?
Well, fairly wealthy. I'm 27.
Yeah, you can play. You know you want him to play.
He can play.
All right, you
see,
can
you
play.
See, you said there was nobody.
All right.
He can play.
I've changed my opinion. You can play, all right?
Okay.
All right, I'm going to put you on hold, and Gary will get all your information.
All right. All right,
you better not be lying, because Robin will cut your balls off.
Okay.
All right. All right, here we go. Hello, you're on the air. He won already, that guy. Why should anybody else call him? Why don't you go out with him?
Will you stop?
Why should we waste time?
You're being very bad.
Well, I just know. It'll take me another hour to find another guy to play.
Stop it. You're jinxing everything.
You're on the air.
No one's good enough for her anyway. It
right.
Seems, oh, well, then we're going to have a dissertation. I'm looking for dates. You got to move along.
Yeah, I can tell from his voice you didn't want him. You're on the air. Yeah, and nobody wants a smart ass.
Paul Harvey. I do commercials.
Your name is what?
Paul Harvey.
Paul Harvey, the...
This is another goof.
From Tennessee.
No, this is the real Paul Harvey. He wants a date with you.
Well, then Paul Harvey's married.
Good day?
Oh, I'm kidding. My right. name's Steve.
Steve, yes.
I work for a medical company. I'm a little nervous. My first time on the air.
Yeah, he sounds too unsure of himself. I know what to do. You're on the air.
Hi, Howard.
All right. Now, what do you do?
I work for a cosmetic corporation.
And what are you, a salesman?
No, actually a chemist. I work in the laboratory.
Now, okay. Now, what is it? You're a chemist at a cosmetics firm.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. You experiment on animals?
No.
Why not?
Little things in
no, actually, I actually produce the product.
Do me a favor. Check it out on the animals first. I prefer to have it checked on an animal than a human. I love animals, but please. That's ridiculous. Now, you, how do they do it without animals? Don't they have to test it to see if somebody's allergic?
Well, no, that's where they actually develop the product. I actually have the formula, and I actually produce
just
the
makes
product.
It.
You are a chemist.
Uh-huh.
Wow. You must make big money.
Pretty good.
I mean,
until Uncle Sam gets it.
Well, I mean, how much money do you make?
Yearly? About 27, 28.
You knowing all that chemistry and developing all these products, you make 27?
Well, I get to keep all the money.
Hmm. Well, Robin, are you interested?
How old are you?
24.
What are these young guys calling me for?
All right. 27 had nothing to do with. Yeah, 27 had nothing to do with young guys. The other guy could have been 19.
You guys are crazy and very cruel.
You're on the air. We know what you want. A pilot's going to win. You're on the air.
Yes, have a good day with Robin.
Are you a Robin fan?
Oh, I am.
And you enjoy looking at her on TV?
I've only seen her a couple of times on television.
I see. You ever masturbate when you watch her?
No. Mm-hmm.
You have a very bad cough, don't you? Lower your radio.
Okay.
This guy might be somebody for you. Let's see.
You think so?
What do you do for a living?
I'm a financial planner.
Well, that sounds like an exciting job. You must make a lot of money.
No, not really.
You know, people can be successful without making a lot of money, Howard.
Hmm. Hello? Hello? You're on the air.
Yes, hi. I'd like to talk to Robin.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes, Robin. Hi. I was wondering about the date.
Yeah, so what do you do?
I just think this is
I'm
hopeless.
I'm retired.
You're retired?
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 31 this month.
Well, wait a second. Let's talk to you. Lower your radio, genius.
I'm sorry.
Was it a disability retirement?
Yes, it is.
Oh, I didn't think of that. Oh, I thought this guy was like one of those wealthy guys. You ever
retired
see that,
before 30.
You ever see that magazine advertisement? It's on TV all the time for this magazine about...
I know exactly
Money
what you're
magazine.
Talking about. Yeah.
Money magazine, they go, this gentleman built his own business and at 28 years old retired and went around the world in a sailboat.
So what? How are you disabled?
I have a back injury.
So what do you do now?
Now I basically hang at home and listen to you guys.
All right, and you make a lot of money being disabled?
No, but the...
All right, why don't you just go out on a date with the airline guy?
Come on,
Howard. Come on, come on, don't be ridiculous.
You've got to do some more screening.
Don't be ridiculous.
I'm not being ridiculous. Those
there is not
good
another
guys.
Guy on this planet that
oh,
is worthwhile to you.
Oh, listen to you.
Oh, come on. Come on. Let's stop the charade. Why don't you go out with the airline guy?
No.
You want me to keep
I want
screening?
I want to play the game.
You want to play the game?
Yes.
Impossible.
This is already a half hour of screening. I found one guy.
Guy has to be rich.
Look,
and
one
single
guy was married.
Good looking, but yet have the time to sit there and call up on the phone.
Right.
The.
Well, I'm going to find it.
All right, fine.
Very, very difficult.
No. Will you. Come on.
All right. All right. You're on the air. Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah, I was calling for Dial-A-Day.
Yes.
Yeah.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a TV writer.
Really? Now that's something that's you're from New York, though.
Yeah.
Are you lying?
No.
How much you make a year?
$300,000.
You make $300,000 a year in your TV writer.
Yeah.
What show do you write for?
I'd rather not say. But it's on NBC.
What do you think of that, Robin?
What do I think of it?
Yeah.
If it was true, it would be nice.
Is it true?
Yeah, it's true. I'm a TV writer, make $300,000 a year.
And do you work at home?
Yeah, I've got a computer.
And it's a hit show?
Yeah.
Are you a good-looking guy? Who do you look like? Who do you look like?
I kind of look like Bob Geldof.
That's a look I like.
Bob Geldof. Robin likes that. Well, that sounds pretty good.
Bye-bye pilot.
Yeah. Suddenly the pilot just... So you want to date this guy, Robin?
Now, wait a minute. We're playing Dial-A-Date. So he, if he wants to play, he can play.
You would let
how
him play.
How old are you?
Hey, how old are you?
34.
Mm-hmm. Do me a favor. Tell Robin who you are.
This is Fred Norris.
You know you guys are really rotten. Really rotten. I knew there was something wrong.
That was Fred.
Anybody who blurts out $300,000 a year.
See, you want a date with Freddie. You were in love.
Get
admit it.
It,
you fell in
you
love
know
with
what?
Fred.
I'm not she was playing here with in Bell.
You
guys
fell
anymore.
In love with Fred.
I'm not playing with you guys.
She was
get
here
on
in
the
Bell's
phone
house.
And find me a date.
You're in Bell's.
You were here in Wedding Bell's,
you guys,
Fred.
You
were engaged.
You're really rotten. All of you.
Oh,
really
man.
Rotten. These are supposed to be my friends.
I know exactly what you're looking for.
I debated the best role.
Fred just gave you guys a. This is who we're looking for. The other rest of you might have hung up.
Hey, come on.
All right, we'll continue playing. I'll take a break. Well, don't you have to
if
do
you're
news?
Gonna play around like this, we'll never find anybody.
You
playing games with Fred.
Do you have any news today?
Of course I have news.
Well, you're gonna have to do that at some point.
She was even a little hesitant.
Yeah.
Because I didn't think it was true.
She's like, well, 300.
Mm. Oh, listen. Oh, yeah.
Fred, you were engaged.
I'm telling you.
No way.
I was wheeling the babies in the car.
No, you said, why don't you go out with this? I said, we have to play the game, didn't I?
Yes.
Yeah. Like
he was going to win.
No way.
Easy. If Fred had played, he would have won.
Well, Fred would win.
That's right.
That's beside the point.
Fred, you would definitely, Robin would definitely do you a couple of times. All right, let's take a break and we'll continue looking for guys. We'll do the news. A musical guest might be stopping by. It's a long shot, but he might be stopping by.
A musical guest?
And it would be great. We would all flip out if this guy showed up.
Really?
We would all flip out.
Oh, okay.
It would be the coolest thing if he showed up.
Well, how do you know?
If he shows up, we got to even interrupt your date, believe it or not.
Well, I don't know about that.
Yeah, you would interrupt for this guy, but I don't know if we can get it together.
Oh, okay.
We're trying. It would be just, he would just walk in.
Yeah?
If it happens, yeah. And all he'd be right. The kind of guy we just want to walk in.
That sounds good.
Yeah. He's that big. In fact, you'd want him to play. All right, we'll take a break. And I should tell you who it is who might drop in.
Who?
Should I tell you who?
Sure.
Gary, come here. Should I tell her? Because if I announce it on the air, I may tell you off the air. But if I announce it on the air, is it going to ruin it? I'm just hoping maybe if we announce it, he would definitely decide to come in.
The chances are so slim. I just spoke to somebody. The chances are so ridiculously slim.
Let me speak to somebody.
Who? There's nobody to speak to. That's how slim they are.
What? There's nobody to speak to?
In other words, our promotions director was going to call a promoter, but she didn't even have his number.
So you mean this is ridiculous?
Right. They told me not to tell you, but I told you anyway.
Oh, so it's not going to happen.
Jackson Brown. Supposed to come in. I mean, all I want him to do is do a couple of songs. It'd be great.
Well, that would have been nice.
Yeah. I could have dug that. So you don't think it's going to happen?
No, I told you that right off the bat.
You have his autograph anyway, don't you?
Yeah.
All right. Let's take a break, and then we'll be back right after these words.
To Baba Booey.
94 WYSP, Howard Stern all morning, classic rock and roll all day.
And that's how they work the whole thing, NBO. NBO understands shopping is a low priority for men. It really is. Very few men like to go shopping.
Mm-hmm.
I hate it. I want to go into a place that has a lot of great prices and a lot of great different stuff, like selected coats, two for $200, sports coats, $50 off, sweaters, 50% off, dress shirts, 50% off, neckwear, 50% off, overcoats, $100, outerwear, $49.90, long sleeve silk sports shirts, $39.90. I'm talking about name brands. Call 1-800-688-EASY, 1-800-688-EASY, or go to any one of the 39 NBO locations near you today. What is it, Gary? What is that? Okay.
We're getting ready to play Dial Day again.
Okay.
Baba Booey.
Let's get into it. Robin, I will now pop down the phones a couple more times. Otherwise, you're dating this airline pilot.
Oh.
I have decided.
That is not fair.
All right. Let's see what we have. So far, we've got an airline pilot who you liked. Robin has agreed in a rare 9-year change of mind to actually go out with one of you slobs.
No. See, now there you go.
All right. Let's go. You're on the air. What would you do? What do you... How much money do you make?
Hello?
Yeah, hi. How much money do you make?
About $250,000.
All right. You see, now everyone's saying that they make a lot of money.
Yeah.
What do you do for a living?
I'm an actor.
This is Michael. Get off the
Boy, that was
And Michael, obviously, Michael Swan, the soap opera star, who has been dating Robin and writing articles about her. Michael, what...
How can you do this to me, Robin?
What do what?
How can you do this?
Oh,
how, you know, you have the most humiliating thing I've ever been through in my life.
Hey, look.
All the time I've invested in you.
Oh, please.
And all the articles I've written about you in the soap opera press.
Michael, let me ask you something. You've been dating Robin. Do you feel any jealousy hearing her looking for dates?
That's why I called.
Are you serious?
I'm furious.
You're furious?
I'm absolutely furious.
Well, from what I understand, you don't get all that romantic.
Who said that?
Who said that?
I never said
you
that.
You said you never did more than make out with him.
I never said anything to you about him.
You said you kissed him.
I never said
you told me you
to
kissed
you,
him.
You asked me if there's any romance involved, and I never answer you.
Listen to this guy's cough. You better stop kissing him.
Yeah, my face is breaking out in these strange splotches.
So what would you like her to be exclusive to you?
No. Now, Robin is a grown-up.
Right.
But I just think it's terrible that she's doing this to me on the air. It's humiliating. I mean, she's going out to the great unwashed.
Is he joking or is he...
I have no clue what's going
you
on.
Are you serious about this?
Of course I'm serious. This is a serious show, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, but I'm saying you would like to see Robin not go on a dial a date. Because
no,
you would like her to make a commitment to you.
I want Robin.
No, he doesn't want me to make a commitment to him.
Because you date a lot of other girls, don't you?
Sure I do, darling. I want Robin to be happy. And if she's going to be happy with a plumber from Long Island, then that's fine.
Well, just because not everyone can be a soap opera star, but the airline pilot
Well, you could be, Howard.
Well, I think Robin wants a man who's exclusive to her.
She does.
And,
Well, here we go with all these suppositions again.
I know.
I just said I wanted to play Diamond.
Yeah, but Robin, the problem is that you...
Robin, I thought you were the nurse. When did Howard turn into the nurse?
You have become increasingly quiet about your opinions on what you want for yourself, and you've become quiet on what you're doing with Michael Swan. I don't know what's going on, so I'm trying to discuss with Michael Swan here what's going on. You've taken yourself out of the conversation. Now you...
Well, Michael, you called in. You're on your own.
I was going to come down there and do a soap opera tirade.
Well, listen,
but I wouldn't get there until too late, so...
Obviously, for you to play would be ludicrous. You already have your own dial-a-date going with her.
That's right.
What does a guy have to do to get Robin? You know, I'm innocent in all this. I'm just trying to get Robin laid.
I think that's pretty much what you're trying to do, Howard.
Right.
But, you know, listen.
Hey, you know what? One of the listeners called and said you did a Playgirl centerfold a few years ago. Is that true?
Yeah, that's right.
I'll have to take it. Did you see it, Robin?
I have never seen it, no.
I will get a copy of it.
But it was in good taste.
And you show your penis?
No. What penis?
You didn't show any swing?
No.
Swing. I'll have to see.
But if you turn the page, there's a big, tall, blonde guy standing next to a banister.
There's no problem with that.
No, absolutely not.
Right. Has Robin seen your swing?
Procter and Gamble weren't too happy about it. No. I don't see how she could have possibly seen it.
Really? Oh, so you haven't gone that far
Smaller yet. Than yours, Howard.
Really? Yeah. Have you ever been married?
Six times.
Is that true?
No.
No,
I've been married twice, Howard.
Really?
Yes.
All right, very good. You got any
and
kids?
He's a good Catholic.
Has he got kids? He's like
right.
Chuck Woolridge.
Listen.
All right, good luck.
In spite of the humiliation, Robin.
All right, very good.
Good luck.
Good. Bye-bye.
Bye.
No, I don't think he cares if you go on a date, does he?
No,
does
I don't
he?
Think so.
Sounds to me like he did. Is that a shtick, or is this guy falling in love with you?
We like each other.
Right. And yet you still feel that you need someone else in your life. True?
She's trying to make him jealous.
I'm not doing anything. I just want
She's trying to make him jealous, you're saying, Jackie?
Yeah, do a dial-a-date. I thought it'd be fun.
All right, let's get back to the date then. Stop planting phone calls.
Please.
You're on the air.
Hello.
Yeah.
Where's Howard, man? I want to date Robin.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Well, you're not good enough already, I can tell.
Oh, come on.
You don't have a smooth voice like that, Michael Swan.
Later for Michael Swan.
Yeah.
You're talking to the hammer.
Oh.
And I want to slam and make the quiver shiver.
Who?
Right.
The hammer.
The hammer can make the quiver shiver.
That's it.
I like you. You're the ball peen hammer, is who you are. All right, listen, ball peen hammer. What do you do for a living?
I'm the director of international marketing for a trading firm.
Yeah, I can tell already. You're not going to date him, are you, Robbie? Come on, let's move it along.
I don't even know what the director
of... Do me a favor. Don't treat this like the other dial of dates who come in here and they shake their head. Just give me yes, no. Let's move it.
Come on,
yes,
Robin,
no.
Baby. Give me a chance.
No, not
right.
Anybody yelling.
Just tell
like
me
that.
No as soon as you know it's no, all right? Yes, you're on the air.
Hello, Howard.
Yes.
How you doing?
All right. What do you do?
I am a business consultant.
In what kind of business?
Financial services. It's a little bit complicated, but basically what we do is we manage portfolios.
If I ever ask for the complete opposite of the other guy, it's this guy.
Here you go. Hey, Robin, how you doing?
Hey, Robin, I'm a... it's a little complicated what I do. I spent 3 years in the slammer, though. It was so complicated the IRS couldn't figure it out, so they just locked me up.
Robin, what kind of food do you like?
What kind of food are you into, Robin?
Oh, just about anything. I like spicy food.
Okay.
Hmm. Yeah, because it makes your hemorrhoids feel good the next day. All right, listen, dude, what do you think? You making a lot of money?
Not a lot. A lot of money, maybe $90,000.
$90,000 is a good salary. I'll tell you that.
Well, you know, when you're in this kind of business, it goes up and down. Last year was a pretty good year.
Yeah. Now you have a lot of clients and stuff. Robin, just say no if you're not. You know.
No, he's all right so far.
You hear me like so far. How old are you?
34.
34, and you make a good living. What do you live in the Manhattan area or?
Actually, I live in New Jersey.
In New Jersey.
I live down the Jersey Shore.
I see. So you got a nice place on the shore.
Yeah.
You own your own home?
Yes, I do.
Oh. You ever been married?
Yes, I was.
And you're divorced now?
Yes, I am.
And you have children?
No, I don't.
Mm-hmm. And you keep yourself in pretty good shape?
Very good shape.
Well, Robin, what do you think of this guy?
He can play.
He can play.
Why don't we let
him
play?
Why don't I put you on hold, sir?
All right, thank you.
What religion are you?
I'm a Catholic, not practicing.
What's your ethnic background?
Irish, German.
All right, hold on. you just have to say no, that's all, and I'll hang up on them. Two guys now evidently fit your description of a man.
We shall see.
Convenient. If you pick him, I gotta see that.
It did make me laugh, that voice.
Yeah, I gotta be behind you, slamming your head into the bedpost. Yeah, so you thought
quiet.
So you thought you were cute on that dial-a-date, huh? Thought you were cute when I was sitting there struggling on the phone.
Now how do you feel? Totally impaled.
Okay. That's two guys. I got to find you a third.
One more to go.
And then we play the game.
All right.
I have to find you a very special man for the third one.
I would hope.
All right, Fred, get back on the phone. We'll be back right after these words.
94 WISP, Howard Stern all morning, classic rock and roll all day.
So, well, did you know that Kitty City is the largest retail toy store in Manhattan and Philadelphia? You thought it was somewhere else, didn't you? Kitty City is the largest supermarket of toys. And you know what? It's about time some really good competition came along. Kitty City. Kitty City, New York, New Jersey, and Philadelphia's official toy store. And you know what I love about Kitty City? Not only the low prices and not only the fact that they put stuff on sale, but the fact that there's a help button there. Because when you shop at these supermarket type, toy stores, there's no help there. Especially when it comes to the electronic games department. At Kitty City, you push a button and someone will come to your help immediately. And what about that layaway plan? Does anyone else do it for you? Kitty City, go on that extra mile. You can pick out all the toys you want for the holidays and then store them at Kitty City. That's where the kids don't find them. And also, you don't have to clutter your house up with toys in your closets. And just before the holidays, pick them up anytime you want. And it allows you to pay out slowly. Kitty City, 34th Street, Union Square, 79th and Broadway in New Jersey, East Hanover, Edison, Old Bridge, Tom's River, and Cherry Hill, Kitty City. 859-923-KROQ, WISP, WJFK. We're here. We're going to do the news for you, but also we're playing Dial-A-Date, a rare Dial-A-Date. Robin Quivers offering herself as a Dial-A-Date, the woman I've worked with for the past 7 years. How many years have I worked with her? How many years have I worked with you, Robin? How many years have I worked with you?
10.
10?
Yeah.
No, come on.
10.
10. 10 years, and I've never seen her offer herself on a date. It took me by surprise. Walked, marched, sashayed herself into the studio.
Sashayed.
At 7 o'clock this morning and said, I want to be on a date, and ran out. And ran out the room.
Now, that doesn't sound likely, does it?
Yeah, but it happened. It doesn't sound likely at all. None of it sounds likely.
You know you put me up to this.
She goes, yeah, I have an announcement, mate. I want to go on Dial Date. And ran out of the room, right?
And it shocked us all, because we all anticipated completely different things, right?
Yes.
What did you anticipate?
Well, we all thought it was going to be about us. About different. Yeah, Fred thought it was going to be about him. Jackie said, uh-oh. And
you're
I was like,
kidding.
I wonder what I did. I wonder what the hell she got on me.
But then she looked down at Gary, and yeah. I thought she had something on Gary.
Yeah.
And then she said,
I love your impression of me, Jack.
Can I hear that impression of what Robin did? Okay. All right, but anyway, never mind. It's happened, and we're in the middle of it. It's two guys have been selected so far. It's been over an hour and a half process just finding guys. Let's see what we have on the phone. Hi, you're on the air, and you're playing Dial a Date if you got the right qualifications. What do you do for a living?
Hello?
Yeah, hi.
Yeah, I just want to boogie with Robin's Black Kloogie.
You want to boogie with her Kloogie?
Yeah.
That's John.
I want to poke a gee.
Get out of here.
I want to poke a gee. I want to poke a Kloogie.
Johnny, we already have a relationship.
Stuttering John.
As far as it's going.
Hey, John. Hey, John. Hey, John.
What's that?
That was very good. You really disguised your voice well.
Nobody told me to.
Oh, they should just call up as John?
Yeah. You know what they told me to say?
What?
I thought we were going to stop this playing and get on with my day.
You know what they told me to say?
Oh, I think he was doing an impression of himself. You know what they told me to say?
What did they tell you to say?
Wiggy!
All right.
No.
You're on the air. Yeah, you're on the air. Hello? Yes, would you like a date? Gary told me to... by the way, Gary told me to give out the phone numbers because the switchboard is swamped.
Yeah.
212-955-9292 is our number here in New York. Everywhere else, if you listen to us, it's 1-800-44-STERN. And in L.A., it's 1-800-23-STERN. S-T-E-R-N. Got my own damn phone numbers. Screw all those numbers. Call 1-800-52-STERN. Order some tapes. Get in on it for Christmas holiday. Yes?
Hi, Howard.
Hi, Robin.
Good morning.
Good morning. I'd like a day with you.
All right. Now, you sound like a well-mannered kind
of
guy.
Well, you know, you have to be in my type of business.
What type of business are you in?
I have a leasing company. We do exotics and classic cars.
Oh, you lease cars?
Yeah. Classics, exotics. That's not far, probably, from your neighborhood.
Well, isn't that nice? Some important job you've got there. I know, Robin, you're hoping for a doctor or something, but...
I don't particularly care for doctors. I knew lots of doctors. I was a nurse, remember?
You make a lot of money?
Discounting this year, usually, yes.
Well, I know it's a rough year for the car business, but what kind of money do you make?
We make, as a rule, you know, considerably over 100.
You sound a little marble-mouthed.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous.
You're nervous.
Usually I'm not.
Why, Robin, a dream girl of yours?
Yeah, Robin's pretty hot, yeah.
Are you going out with her just to get close to me? You trying to work that angle, or what?
No.
I'm not renting any cars from you, my friend.
You're not much of a coffee, are you, Howard?
No, I already have DeFeo as a sponsor. What do I need you for?
This is true.
So,
we don't lease those type of cars.
You can play. Well, how old are you?
30.
What was that?
30 even?
30. 30 even.
30 even.
That's considerably younger than you, Robin, not to embarrass you.
Considerably?
I mean, that really is.
You're older than 30?
I don't look it, though.
No, she looks very young. She looks like she's 29.
Well, Robin's got that late 20s look.
Yeah, and you like to give the good gay sheesh?
Hey, wait a minute now.
And you're a gentleman?
Absolutely.
Have you ever
been a good-looking guy?
I'd say very good-looking.
Really?
5'10", sandy hair, blue eyes.
And have you been married?
No. Knock on wood.
Why, you don't want to get married?
At the moment, no.
Well, Robin, she's got your kind of attitude.
They're very good.
All right, Robin says you can play.
Great, thanks, Robin.
Robin, are you sure?
Yeah, he can play.
All right.
So we've got our three candidates.
All right, hold on.
Something they said wouldn't happen.
All right, well, you can play. You're smart, because, listen, I got to say something to you. That guy sounds like a load. No offense. I mean, what a load. Boy, what you're attracted to.
Listen, I've heard the girls over the years that you've been attracted to, and I don't think much of them either.
Well, I'm not dating them.
Yeah, but you try.
I would. All right, well, there it is.
The lines can be closed now. We've got our three contestants.
We have three contestants, and I know there's a lot of disappointed guys. Well, let's just say, who knows, maybe one of these guys can end up getting disconnected. You never know, so keep hanging
Stand
in there.
Stand by.
All right, Robin, it's 9:05. What I'm going to do here is ask you for a couple of news stories, not to keep these guys waiting too long. Gary, why don't you check up on them periodically, make sure they're still there. Make sure they haven't passed out from their good luck.
Baba Booey.
So... Robin, can a rich, famous person still override contestant number three?
No, that wouldn't be fair.
That would not be fair. No, it wouldn't. All right, I was just testing. Make sure you were still sane. That guy made my skin crawl. But all right, hey, maybe he's a great guy. Maybe Robin knows something I don't know.
You never know.
By the way, our own Fred Norris found love on the Dial a Day game. Maybe this will be the one you love, Robin.
No, I don't know about that. All right, let's see. A couple of stories.
You know, you ought to ask Fred to help you decide.
I told you I was going to rely heavily on Fred.
Fred, you never thought Dial-A-Date would work out for you, did you?
Not in a million years.
Robin, did that enter into your decision to
Absolutely.
Go on Dial-A-Date? It did.
Was one of the reasons.
Because you're very happy, aren't you, Fred?
Yeah.
And when she walked in, you were immediately attracted, right?
Smitten.
You were smitten, seriously?
Smitten.
It was love at first sight for you?
Totally.
What about for her?
I don't think it was for her.
Really?
No.
Well, that's what
I
she
know
says.
It was for me. Well, that's what she says.
Well, we just can't imagine not falling in love with you at first sight.
And I mean, to me, when I looked at you, when I first met you in Hartford, I was in love.
We fell in love with you at first sight.
Yes. I'm wondering if it's love for her yet.
I keep asking her that every day.
And you're very happy together. And when she walked
dodges
in,
the question.
Like, you looked at her and said, I think this is a girl I love.
I want to marry her.
I don't know if I put it in those words, but yeah, there was definitely a strong feeling.
Something that, and you started talking to her, and immediately you fell in love
Instant
with her.
Instant rapport.
Really?
Yeah.
And you've never felt that with anyone else?
No.
Wow. Well, sounds like you better go out and buy your own yarmulke. That's a serious commitment.
Yeah, it's time for you to stop borrowing.
Me
yeah.
and Pete Capshaw.
All right, very good, Fred. Excuse me, I just have to check out this obscure reference. You and Kate Capshaw?
Yeah, she's marrying Steven Spielberg in a traditional Jewish ceremony.
Oh,
I only understand Fred's joke.
All right, very good.
Check with me.
Thank you, Fred. I can see why you make so much money as a writer. All right, very good. You're really in touch with the public. All right, go ahead, Robin.
Well, Howard, of course, we're all waiting with bated breath today.
All of us, including Kate Capshaw.
For the hearings the new hearing
to
determine whether Judge Thomas practiced sexual harassment.
Now, hold it on. Wow.
Yeah, they start today, and they'll be on television everywhere.
Listen, we're all just very happy he's dating black women. We think that's
great. Well, he couldn't get a date with black women.
So maybe he should go to the white women.
Harassing them.
He should get some fat, ugly white women.
Well, he married a white woman.
She's not exactly skinny, is she? Hey, listen, you're never going to be able to decide these allegations inside of a weekend. I mean, it's going to be whoever can tell the best story. You know, some guys get nervous under pressure. You know, guys start seeing...
Well, and now is his time. He needs to perform.
He certainly
he
does.
He needs to perform well. You know, his accuser will also have to take the stand, and she will have to perform well.
Look, I've seen Judge Thomas. I'm going to tell you my read on just Judge Thomas. I've seen his wife. If my wife had a caboose like that, I'd watch some porno, too. I'm going to be honest with you. All right? You want to talk caboose, Robin?
Look at his caboose. Now, come on.
Hey, nothing wrong with that. Look, he ain't the best-looking guy. He tried to pick up a couple of hot young chicks. Take a look at the cover of the Daily News. I'll tell you something.
He was way out of his league.
He was just way out of his league.
He was trying to use that position for something.
What a drag. You think a guy who's like a judge and everything pulled himself up by his bootstraps?
Well, I let him play Dial-A-Date.
You're not kidding, you would. I think, you know, they should have let... I mean, I can't believe... I really cannot believe that these girls wouldn't go with him. That's the most shocking of all the allegations.
Isn't that amazing? That you think a woman is going to be attracted just because the guy is a judge? You're talking about one Harvard lawyer to a
Robin,
Yale lawyer.
You know a little more than the average person. Look at the girl. The good-looking girls are coming here and are attracted to me because I'm on the radio.
Yes, but they aren't Harvard law students.
I don't know. Some of them are.
No, I haven't seen one.
Well, I'll tell you something. I mean, this woman, if she's not telling the truth, is going to ruin this guy's entire career.
Well, if she's not telling the truth, she's ruined her own.
That's true, too.
And that's a considerable step to take as well.
Yeah, you know something? I might have to agree with her. I haven't heard any of the evidence. You know what? I don't even know. I don't care. My head's going to explode just from you being on
Dial-A-Date.
Well,
that's what they say will have to happen. Right. This Anita Hill will have to prove she just didn't suddenly invent these charges.
Mm-hmm.
She will have to... answer the questions about her motivation for revealing this.
Yes.
She will also have to tell them why she didn't come forward immediately. There has to be some sort of historical perspective put on this.
Right.
Why now? And then she'll also have to explain why she has had a continued relationship with this man, if that is the case.
You know, from the neck up, this guy's a genius, but from the waist down, he's Ted the janitor. He's, you know what I mean? He's just like...
Isn't every man, though?
Let's play some Road. Well, that's the problem. You girls have no idea what it's like to be a man with the buildup that we have in our pants. I mean, it's really painful sometimes. We have to sometimes resort to talking about bestiality with you girls just to get you to do something. That's that.
Now, that's some of the things they'll have to determine about Thomas. Hmm. Does he have a history of talking to women about sexual matters like porno flicks?
Hello, baby. Did you see that movie with the donkey?
Has he made contradictory statements about his relationship with Hill? Because apparently at one point he told the FBI that he had asked her for a date, and then he told the Senate GOPers that he never did.
I see. It's sort of like Gary this morning. First he said he didn't sign James Taylor's picture. Then he said that James Taylor signed it. And then he said maybe the publicist signed it.
Yeah.
I see.
Will this be the end? Stay tuned.
I think it could be the end.
Meanwhile, the
But I think, I will I tell you, I think he will,
persevere?
Yeah.
And go to the full?
Yes.
You think they'll make the confirmation vote, and will he win?
Yes.
Oh, wonderful.
That's what I was trying to say. What do you think?
I don't know. This is an awfully murky... You know, can you have a guy sitting on the court who has a cloud hanging over him?
Well, what do you think is going to happen? Just give me your guess.
I think this will be it. I think he will not win confirmation. I think he'll get through this hearing, and then when it comes to the full Senate, he won't be confirmed.
Fred, what do you think? You agree with Robin? Jackie, I'm not going to ask you what you think because you haven't picked up a paper in 5 years.
He doesn't even know what we're talking about.
All right, let's see what happens. Anybody want to bet on it?
I ain't betting with Robin.
You know what? I'm not betting any of you guys.
Nobody here pays anybody.
Right.
So don't keep saying it's just me. President Bush yesterday denounced pornography, particularly child pornography, as a horror.
Isn't that a brave stand?
Stopped by parents and law enforcement authorities.
What a brave guy President Bush is. Gee, what was it? One issue, the American flag, and now this other big issue is child pornography. You know, he's too used to being the vice president. That's the kind of issues the vice president gets behind. Everybody's against child pornography, except for guys who are sick.
Pornography degrades and insults both men and women.
Prude.
And we've all heard the stories of innocent children drawn into the world of pornography, victimized by crimes whose consequences are beyond imagination.
Listen, I wish everyone would stop acting so hoity-toity. I'm going to say this. It's not the most popular thing to say, but everybody enjoys pornography, 90% of the people. You see what movies, you see the business the pornography industry does? Home video rentals and sales?
Yeah, everybody agrees 100% child pornography is wrong.
Yeah, I mean, come on, we all know that. I mean, he's not, big deal, he said that.
But adults fooling around and watching a movie.
Come on.
Perfectly all right.
Want to watch a few people banging away, I say leave them the hell alone. Let them do their thing. I want to watch. I like it. I like to watch it. You're damn right I like to watch. I like to watch and see what I'm not getting. I got a spanking movie at home. I'm not giving it up. I don't care what law they pass.
We had no kids in it.
I had to sneak home that copy of The Masseuse with Hypatia Lee.
You like that?
I got a pornography collection to make you sick.
Now, do you hide your movies?
Of course.
Where?
None of your business.
So your wife doesn't know they're there and the kids don't know?
No, my wife knows, of course. I tried to show them to her.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
She doesn't want to watch?
She for 5 seconds, he goes, there's no story, there's no buildup, it's disgusting. I go, one time, about a month ago, I forced her to sit there and watch it. I said, you do everything that they're doing in that movie.
Yeah.
That's what I wanted. That's the game we're playing tonight.
Uh-huh.
I must have pulled out of my collection a worse friggin' movie. Because I had the worst night.
Your one opportunity, and you pulled out a bad film.
Yeah, oh. It was all the stuff she did already.
Oh, jeez.
Stupid as I am.
You should have been prepared for that moment.
No, I know. I watched that porno. I swear to you. I finished before the whole opening credits. It takes me a year to watch one porno movie. That masseuse is a good movie.
Yeah?
Oh, yes.
But what's the story there? Is there a story?
This is real good. This really good-looking guy walks in, right? And Hypatia Lee is the masseuse.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she's going to be on our TV show.
Oh, is she?
She went and auditioned yesterday, and I heard she just came in front of everyone and just ripped her clothes off.
All right.
She's a big star. I had no idea.
Me neither. I didn't know.
How did you find out?
At Grand Central yesterday at the signing, about 10 different guys came up and said, I can't believe you guys had Hypatia Lee or whatever.
Yeah, no one even knows her name. Hiawatha.
Well, I don't know it, but they're like, wow, I've been following her for
years. She evidently was brought down to the TV station yesterday.
Yeah.
And had to audition. So they said, would you mind trying on some bathing suits? So she says, oh, no. And she ripped her clothes off. And they go, no, you have to go change in the other room. No, that'll be ridiculous. In front of everyone, the interns, everyone. It's just ripping her clothes off.
Well, I said to Jackie, it's very obvious that she is a nudist. She likes being in front of people.
Even when people are dressed.
I think you call that an exhibition.
Were you there for that, Gary?
I missed the part where she was completely nude in Dan's office, although everyone enjoyed that.
Yeah.
But I was there for the part where she got, first she tried on a bunch of tops. Then she tried on a bunch of bottoms, but she was never, with the time she wasn't naked all at once.
Right.
But her top was off for a while. She tried on like 5 different tops.
Yeah.
Then they found one she liked. She said, okay, now we're trying a bunch of bottoms.
Yeah, great.
Oh.
Yeah. And there were, I'd say there was 10 people in the room, all interns and talent
all
coordinators.
Everybody.
Yeah. As far as I'm concerned, she's a supermodel. So, you want another plot of the masseuse?
Yeah.
All right. Then we got to get to your guys and do your rest of your news. But
right.
So, this guy comes in, right? And he lays down on the table, gets in a towel, and she's wearing a uniform. Except you can kind of see her breasts hanging out of the uniform a little bit. But she's wearing a uniform, and she, as far as she's concerned, she's not fooling around in this case. She's giving him a legitimate massage.
Yeah.
He tries coming on, he grabs her a couple of times. She says, look, I'm not interested in that. I'm a legitimate masseuse. He says, come on, help me out. I'm a virgin. I'm very embarrassed. She goes, I don't care. I'm not helping you out. The guy says, hey, do me a favor. Would you mind shaving me?
The guy says
that. Yeah. She goes, I never heard of a guy wanting to be shaved. It's one of the stranger requests. Not the most strange, but strange. He says, do you mind doing it? She goes, no, I'll do that for you. She shaves him. Shaves him. Right?
His face?
No. Come on. And suddenly there it is, the friggin' Eiffel Tower.
Oh, geez.
He's a little bit to the side. You know what I'm saying?
It's leaning.
Yeah, the guy's huge. So anyway, then he says, look, you got to help me out here. She goes, you a cop? She's still wearing a uniform, right?
Uh-huh.
Says, I need a little something. She gives him a little, just a little something.
What do you mean? Is she asking for monetary?
No.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Right. She gives him a really thorough rub down.
I see.
And then she pulls off her top. And that's all that happens. Which is very interesting. You don't see it. Usually it's just like everybody wham bam, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I didn't get to the rest. That's as far as I got.
Oh, so we're not even finished with the movie.
No, I'll let you know on Monday what happens.
Okay, well, let me tell you that in New Jersey, a postal worker went on a rampage yesterday at his former post office, his former place of business, after he went to the home of his supervisor who had gotten him fired and killed her and her fiancé.
What is it with these postal workers? You know what it is? You can't fire postal workers. I'll tell you why. Because really, if you're a postal worker, it's pretty much bottom-of-the-line stuff sometimes. And what else are you going to go do? What are you qualified to do?
Apparently, in April of 1990, he was fired because he threatened this Carol Ott.
Carol Ott?
Yeah.
Is she that supermodel?
No, that's Alt.
Oh, Alt.
Ott. And so yesterday he went to her house. He also rigged his own room in a boarding house with some explosives.
Oh, yeah, I saw that on TV.
Right. And then he went to her house. He had a samurai sword, and she had several stab wounds on her body. They think he hacked her to death with the samurai sword.
Great date.
They also say that he shot the fiancé. And then he went to the post office where they all used to work, took over the building, shooting two postal workers who were there.
Oh, man.
And then holding police at bay for 4.5 hours before he finally turned himself in.
Imagine you're a postal worker just trying to get through life. And look at the dregs you got to work next to.
Oh, yeah, well, they all said, you know, he was kind of strange. He used to show up for work in jungle fatigue.
Oh, man.
Haven't I told you about that?
Oh, man, those should be outlawed. Not guns, just jungle fatigues. Where are you, the friggin' jungle? I mean, really, what do they got jungle fatigue? Camouflage.
When he finally gave up, Harris was packing a machine gun, hand grenades, ammunition, and a samurai sword.
I see.
So he had a whole arsenal of weapons. Nobody in the house who lived with him knew about that. They said he was very talkative. His sister says he started to change about 10 years ago and get kind of weird.
Yeah.
Never talked to anybody. They never saw him bringing any guns, and they never knew that anything like this was going through his mind.
So what's the deal? Is the mail going to be late?
Oh, sweet.
Well, that's a legitimate question. We got to take a break, Robin. When we come back, you'll finish the news, and then one of these lucky three men on the phone is going to get to win you in a date.
Mm.
And have his way with you.
Oh, no. Nobody has their way with me.
Well, we'll see about that. 920, we'll be back right after these words.
94 WYSP, Howard Stern all morning, classic rock and roll all day.
No cholesterol, low sodium, made from real butter, with the fat and water having been removed. Only the flavor remains. You have the flavor of butter. You sprinkle it on hot, moist foods, and it's delicious. You can put it on your baked potatoes, on your fish, your noodles, your steamed vegetables, your rice, hot cereal, soups. You can use it in baking or cooking. Switch to Butter Bud Sprinkles. Throw out that stick of butter and go to Butter Bud Sprinkles. You will love them. Thank you. 926 923 KROQ WYSP WJFK. We're doing the news, and then we'll get back to Robin's dial-a-date, and then it'll be the end of the show. 926. Hey, where's Robin? How come she disappears now every break? What is it, every break? She got ants in her pants? Where is Robin? What is going on here? Everybody's running around. It's all kind of excitement. I don't understand it. Robin, what is it? Every break you disappear and then...
What?
What is it? Every break you disappear?
No, I have to go get warm water.
Warm water? Why don't you have one of the interns do that for you?
They can't do it.
No one can do that. You mean they can't get warm water?
No, they can't figure that out.
Wait a second. All right, never mind. I don't care.
When Susan's here, it's a handle. She's not here, and Ganji's like, I can't do that.
Ganji can't handle hot water?
No, it's a whole...
What?
Whole social scene in the office.
Is that what's going on?
Yeah,
yeah, that's what I thought. The middle of a newscast. How unprofessional.
No.
You're Dan Rather.
Yeah, I don't know what Jackie's talking about.
Yes.
Go ahead, Robin.
They make up stories. Anyway, at St. John's University yesterday,
yes,
a 17-year-old freshman was raped in the campus gymnasium. The same day, three guys were thrown out of school because of a sexual attack last year. They say this time it wasn't a student, though.
Oh.
And this guy, Keith Howie, is being held on $30,000 bail. He claimed to have been a former student and to have been contemplating going back to the school again, but they say they have no record of him ever having attended. But he apparently met this girl a week or two ago. Made a date with her.
Yeah.
And they went and watched a basketball game together, and then he allegedly attacked the woman in an isolated area on the top floor of the gymnasium.
Hmm.
Now, this Howie guy, he admits to the police that there was sexual contact with the girl, but he says it was consensual.
Oh, boy.
So, there you go.
Hmm.
And finally this morning, well, a couple of things, but yep. First off, this. In Boston University, a panel has been studying the doctoral dissertation of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King.
Yeah.
And they have come out with their determination. The determination is that he did plagiarize passages in his dissertation.
Oh.
There is no question there were a lot of areas where he would not give credit for quotes that he took from certain sources, mistakenly credited or credited generally and at some distance in the text from a close paraphrase or a verbatim quotation.
You better sit on this information.
Oh, no.
Because
I think the truth will set us free. Isn't that what they say?
Oh, my God. I mean, you know, this is the one big hero.
Well, they're not going to take away. They said, you know, overall, the strength of the dissertation is such
right.
that they're not going to take away his doctorate.
I see.
But they will add a little note that he could have been a little bit more forthcoming with those footnotes.
Hey, look, you know the spin on this.
What?
Hey, all you people love Kennedy, man, and look at him. He was cheating in the White House, so there you go. Right?
Is that it?
Yeah, I got it. Okay. I'm a spokesman for the black community. Ask me anything about the Dr. King dissertation, I can tell you about it.
Okay, I told you about...
Y'all love that. Y'all love that Kennedy, and look at him. He was president. Okay, number one, he cheated on his wife. Number two, he wasn't the man we thought he was because he was with the mafia. And yet we all love him. So what you putting down Dr. King for? Big deal. So he cheated on his test. Big deal. How's that? You like that, don't you?
I don't know. I don't think that the two have anything to do with each other.
Oh, yes. They'll link it up.
Dallas police are still trying to find CJ. I told you that was a woman who called into a radio show and said she had gotten AIDS. And now she was going to have as much sex as possible, trying to infect as many men as possible before she goes.
Yeah.
They say they're keeping a list now of possible women who could be CJ.
Oh, please. It's probably a prank call. What's the matter with them? It's probably Captain Jenks.
With the guilt she's feeling, she'll probably turn herself in or be cooperative when she's caught, oh, yeah. According to police authorities.
Forget about this BJ or whatever.
CJ.
CJ. This is a BJ, bro.
No. Actress Debbie Reynolds has created a controversy.
What's her problem?
She was talking to the Valley Women's Conference in Fresno, California 3 weeks ago.
I bet you she's CJ. Is she CJ Robin?
No.
She's not a suspect?
She's not on the list.
Right.
In an interview on KFTV television, yes. Reynolds talks about the employment prospects of Hispanics. And she said, well, I think, of course, that the Hispanic population now is so large, and I do think that the job opportunities are more difficult. I think that were I, you know, Hispanic, or if I were as I was, we were a very poor family. I believe there is a lot of domestic work.
Right.
That's what she said. And now all the Hispanic women are very upset with Debbie.
Why are they upset with that?
She said that was a terrible, gross stereotype to just say they should go into domestic work and not have every opportunity open to them.
Whenever somebody is honest about the real... Honest. She's not saying anything wrong. What do you think most of your Latinos come into this country do? They do domestic work. What's the matter with you? And there's less jobs available. How many domestics can we have? But that's no stereotype. Take a look at the statistics. Consuela, come here. Come on. Stop it with the nonsense. Every ethnic group is offended. Stop being so offended. Everyone's so offended. Just make something of yourself. And you know, she's right. There aren't enough jobs here for that kind of work. How many people have the income of a Debbie Reynolds can employ Consuela? You come here, you don't speak any English, you don't want to learn the language. What do you think you're going to be doing? What are you going to be, running, what are you going to be, an engineer? No. A doctor? No. You're going to be doing some kind of manual labor. What is it that she's saying that's so outrageous? It's a stereotype. You come here and you don't speak the language. If I went over to Italy and couldn't speak Italian, what kind of job would I have? I'd pick lettuce in Italy. All right, shut up. All right, go ahead, Robin.
That's what's happening.
Very good, Robin. Once again, you've done a great job. 933-923-KROCK-WYSPWJFK. I like when you bring out the truth. All right, there are three men anxiously awaiting your favors, Robin. And it's time to get to them. I could sense you were a little nervous about
this. I'm nervous?
You are a little. Come on, admit it. You're a little nervous anticipation.
This. You sit there interpreting me, and people think you know what you're talking about.
There's a little nervous anticipation.
Of what? Talking to people on the phone?
Well, it's exciting. You have three men vying for your attentions. Most women would want something like this. And this is probably a little bit of a fantasy you're playing out here. Three men vying for your attentions, trying to impress you, to persuade you.
So this would make me nervous.
A nervous anticipation, excitement, yes. It's a lot of spotlight on you right now. All right, so why don't we take a commercial break?
I wish you would sometimes ask me how I feel as opposed to always telling me. That's just, all I wish.
Because it's never as good. We'll be back right after these words.
94 Morning, classic rock and roll all day.
They really are.
All right, you're number one, right?
Yeah, Howard.
Okay, your name is Ash?
Yeah.
All right. Is that because you're a pain in the ass?
No, that's short for Ashley.
I see. And you say you're 27 years old and you're an airline pilot.
Well, actually, I'm a corporate pilot, like I said.
Right. In other words, a bunch of businessmen fly back and forth. Like, where do you fly to every day?
Well, I fly out of Westchester Airport, right. LaGuardia, JFK, Newark.
So, how big a plane?
Well, it holds about 12 passengers.
Right, I've been on those planes.
Yeah, Falcon 10.
Those are the ones they almost died in, Robin. Remember?
The Learjet.
So if you and Robin were on a date, would it be possible, or would the potential be there, that you could actually take her up in a plane and take her somewhere exciting?
Oh, it's a possibility. There are times when I'm flying alone because they've already dropped off passengers, and I got to make another trip. So there is times where I'm alone in New York with the plane.
All right, and so you're allowed to use this plane.
Occasionally. I'm pretty good with the company executives.
So where would you take Robin on a date? Let's the most romantic date you could think of. I mean, would it involve the plane?
Possibly. Mm-hmm. We could fly down to Virginia for breakfast or something in the morning. Or
you would actually fly her down to Virginia for breakfast?
Sure.
Then where would we lunch?
Boy, oh boy, are you...
We can lunch at Key West.
Well, let me ask you something. Can you put that plane on autopilot and have some sex with her?
Well, that's possible. I wouldn't recommend it, but...
Have you ever done that?
Have you done that?
No.
Have you had sex in the plane?
No.
You have not?
No.
Now,
not while it was in the air.
Now, in other words, so let's say you go to Virginia for breakfast, and, uh-huh. And then where would you go for the afternoon?
Like I said, we could go to Key West.
You could literally get her to Key West.
Sure. These planes are fast. They're faster than your average airline.
Right. And you've never had any close calls or anything like that?
Not really, no. I have a pretty safe record. I haven't had any trouble.
What do? You fly with a parachute or something?
No.
Why is it that each passenger on an airline isn't given a parachute, Robin?
Well, they'd be sitting there thinking, well, now I'm going to die.
Well, I just think that I know going up in a plane, I would like to carry a parachute with me.
Well, the plane goes too fast, and you probably will get sucked into the engines. That's why they don't bother with it.
Oh, wow.
Well,
you really...
they've saved you, Howard.
Wow, you really know your stuff, don't you? So you mean, in other words, if I was on a regular commercial airline flight and I was to jump, I would get sucked into the engine.
That's a good possibility, yeah.
Right.
Ooh, that'd be really messy.
Yeah. I'd rather just hit the ground.
Take your chances.
Well, now you're not saying Robin will get sucked in this date, will you?
Oh, no, don't worry. She won't have to jump.
I see.
I'll make sure she lands all right.
Now you sound like a pretty intelligent guy. Have you ever had your IQ measured?
Yeah, I've had IQ tests.
And what do you register at?
I can't remember exactly. The last time I had it when I was a kid, it was pretty high.
It was very high? You were good in school?
Yeah.
Did you go to college?
Above average.
Did you go to college?
Yes.
You did?
I went to Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. It's in Daytona Beach.
Embryo Aeronautical.
Embry-Riddle.
Embry-Little?
Embry-Riddle.
Embry-Riddle.
Yeah.
Embry-Riddle.
This is how to fly.
Yes. Embry-Riddle.
Right.
Robbie, don't try to be funny during this. I'm trying to find you a man.
Okay, all right.
I'm doing questioning here. You want serious questioning or not?
I'll I'll be quiet.
So you were considered to have a high IQ, you say?
Yeah, pretty. Yeah,
and yet
above
on your
average.
On your SATs, did you do well?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah, I scored 500.
Mm-hmm. And then, when you dress, you scored what? 500.
Combined?
Well, on each one.
On each
it came
one.
Out to 1,000.
So you scored 1,000.
Yeah.
I tell you, I did better than you. All right, listen.
So you can be a pilot, Howard. Now you know. Something else you can do.
Do you wear glasses?
No.
So can you be a pilot with having a vision problem?
Not a commercial pilot, no.
I see. Now, why aren't you a commercial pilot?
Why am I not an airline pilot?
Right.
I'm a corporate pilot because right now I'm making more money because I work for a good company.
Yeah.
And the airlines are kind of hurting, and the pay isn't as good as it used to be.
How do you react to the statement that a pilot is essentially a glorified limousine driver?
Well, I don't really react to that at all because I do it basically for the fun of it. I do have other talents, but I do it for pure fun.
Now, what are your other talents that you think that you have?
Well, I'm a musician. I do other things.
Now, so in other words, if you were on a date, you could serenade Robin, couldn't you?
Oh, sure, yeah.
All right, I recommend. What do you play?
What do I play?
Yeah.
The guitar.
All right, why don't you go get your guitar and make up a little song. Sing now to Robin, a love song.
Okay.
All right, well, yeah, I like this guy's attitude. You see, he says okay.
Go get her.
Go ahead, go get your guitar.
All right.
We'll give you a second.
Go and get his guitar.
I like this guy, Robin. A little young for you, but I like him.
What is young for me? You don't know what's young for me.
Why are you playing that? While he gets his guitar, Fred?
That's the waiting music.
Right.
Okay, I'm here with my guitar.
All right, he's back.
Oh, what do you want to hear? What kind of music? Anything?
Well, you decide it's Robin. You know her.
You're trying to woo me.
You're wooing her, and I'm going to eliminate myself from the, from the discourse.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I'll play her something original.
Mm-hmm. I'll tell you, if you don't pick them, I'll pick them. Anything by Teeny Others? Well, maybe number two will be better.
It's not Fly.
No. Did he write this?
He said this is original.
Oh. I hope he's a good pilot. Well, I would have preferred you did something that I knew.
I could do something, you know.
Go ahead.
It's just a little out of tune because I just took it out of the case. But here, I'll do something, you know.
Because basically he can play. We can determine that.
Well, he plays about as good as I do so far. I could serenade you like that. Where's my guitar, Fred?
You're going to get another dialogue.
I can serenade you. Yeah, why not? Maybe you'll choose me. I wish I had a parachute now, I'll tell you that.
Oh, so he can't sing.
All right. Yeah, what do you need a guy who sings? He can fly a plane. He has a way of making
That's
a living.
Right. It's a much more practical thing to be able to do.
Let's take you to Virginia for breakfast. All right, let me ask him a couple more questions. Hey!
Find out what he looks like again.
Yeah, I will. I'm not even up to that yet. My grilling hasn't, this is just the easy part.
I see.
It gets worse.
He's going to sing this whole song.
Jesus, how do we get him back?
How was that?
All right, not bad.
Very good.
All right, now you say that you have a good sense of humor.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, what makes you laugh?
What makes me laugh?
Yeah, what makes you laugh?
Beside this show.
I'm assuming that it makes you laugh.
I like the Dice Man.
Dice Man you like?
Yeah, like, I guess Jackie Mason's okay once in a while.
All right, okay. What about your sexual appetite? Have you ever been with two women at the same time?
No.
You've never experienced that?
No.
So are you sexually promiscuous?
I wouldn't say so. I'd say I'm pretty, I have a large appetite, but...
But you keep it somewhat controlled?
I like a monogamous relationship.
Right. You've learned portion control, like on Nutrisystem.
Right.
Now you...
I'm not into gluttony or anything like that.
By the way, just to show that this guy is not such a great guitar player.
Mm-mm.
Well, it was out of tune.
Robin, I love you.
That sounds pretty good.
Howard.
Yeah,
Howard.
I just wanted you to understand how bad I am as a guitarist.
Howard.
All right, now go get me a plane. I want to fly one.
Hey, Howard.
Look at John coming in. John, you play as good as me. That's the sad part.
Howard.
And you're a musician. What is it?
I know. I was way out of tune. I could play much better than
I know. I'm sure you can.
I didn't have time to
do it. Have you ever been
on
with
short
a...
short notice.
Let me, at short notice, you did just fine. At least you didn't have that attitude. Like, I don't want to sing. That's what we were looking for. I know what Robin's looking for in a man. A guy who has some sense of excitement, who's not a big pussy. All right. You ever been with a woman who had cans like our own Miss Quivers?
I don't... Well,
you like
pretty
big,
much.
You like big cans. What do you like so much about Robin? That's what I'm curious.
Well, I think she has a good sense of humor.
Right.
I really like her smile. I think she's very pretty.
You think she's pretty, and you would like to perhaps get into her pants, wouldn't you?
Well, I'd like to get to know her first.
Let me ask you something. Are you the type of guy who would tell all his friends that, hey, guess what, I banged Robin Quivers?
No.
I think you would, wouldn't you?
Nah.
In a way, it would be kind of exciting.
No, I'm not into the publicity like that.
No.
That's what they all tell me.
What religion are you?
Well, I'm a Christian.
You
I'm
are a
Catholic,
Christian.
Yeah.
And you've never been married?
No.
Who do you look like that's famous?
Who do I look like? I guess some people say I look like JFK. Some people say I look like David Cassidy.
Really? You're that good looking? Well, women must come on to you all the time.
Well, yeah, I do all right.
Mm-hmm. And you know how to use your tongue?
Excuse me?
I mean, do you...
Everything's in working
I said you're
order,
kind
yeah.
of young. You're kind of young.
Oh, am I kind of young?
Yes.
I'm 27.
Ever had a homosexual experience?
No.
Yo, oh, come on. Even as a young boy?
Nope.
Nothing ever happened where someone came on to you, being that good looking?
Oh, people have come on to me, yeah.
Oh,
a lot of homos.
So you were a young guy, and a couple of homos came
on
to you.
Yeah, all the time. I had a guy grab my ass once in a bar.
Really? You're that good looking? Unfortunately, I've never had any guy grab my ass. You're in good shape, huh?
Yeah.
What do you do to work out?
A couple of push-ups, not much.
You just see a naturally good physique?
Yeah. I used
what
to
do
be,
you weigh?
I used to be athletic. What do I weigh? About 160.
And how tall are you?
5'11".
5'11".
Dark hair.
Dark hair, huh?
Yeah.
And how big is your weenie?
Oh, damn.
Well, I guess we can measure that some other time.
What do
you
mean?
Don't have to answer that.
It's very,
Robin, please. I think it's important.
Well, it's ample.
Really?
Yeah.
No complaints?
No.
And when you just said you use a public urinal?
Excuse me?
Do you use a public urinal?
Sure.
Or do you go to the stall?
If I have to.
Do you pee like a woman?
No.
All right. Hold on, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Now, that was Bachelor number one.
That was number one. I think he stood the test very well. I didn't think he was an a-hole at all. I have no trouble recommending him. We'll be back 9:52 right after these words.
The Howard Stern All Morning. Classic rock and roll all day.
Tell me what you need, and we'll get it for you. All you got to do is dial 1-800-MATTRESS. Don't pay until you get delivery. What do you want? Sealy, Posturepedic, Serta, Perfect Sleep for Simmons, Beauty Rest? What do you want? On one of those beds, they even have a trade-in deal. And who gives you this? Dial a mattress. They give you two-hour delivery, even on weekends. Come on. At night? Instead of sitting around waiting for a delivery all day? And, you know, you'd be surprised. Nobody thinks in advance to get a mattress. When you need a mattress, suddenly you just want it. Or maybe you're having company over and you need a cot or a king-size mattress. You just need it that day. You don't want to wait months for delivery. You don't want to wait 6 weeks like at a department store. And then finally they give you a delivery date and you don't know if they're coming in the morning or in the afternoon. You've got a job to do. Dial 1-800-MATTRES. Leave off the last S for savings. That's Dial the Mattress.
Thank you.
Damn, that was a good read. Except I didn't read. It was a good something. That was a damn good commercial I just did. Concise, got to the point.
Absolutely. Sounded like you knew what you were talking about.
Was convincing.
And believed it.
I might be the next Ed McMahon. I'm a hell of a salesman. Look, let this guy just pop his head in.
Okay.
All right, Gary, let him pop his head. He can't play. I got to tell him he can't play because you got to call in on the phone for this. But let me explain to him the rules. Gary said he just walked right in off the street. He was kind of an interesting character.
A character? Oh, God.
Tommaso.
Tommaso, hi. Hi, Tommaso.
Have a seat.
How you doing?
And put on these he's looking at Jackie like he's Robin.
Yeah. Tommaso, what's your deal?
Put these on.
Are you
so
a...
Put these on, Tommaso, so you can hear Robin.
Tommaso, are you a fan of ours?
Yes, sir.
Really?
Yeah.
And you would like a date with Robin?
Is that what I'm here for?
I didn't tell you. I thought that's what you were here for. What is it you want, then?
Well... Am I on the air?
Yes.
Oh, well, I'm Tommaso. I'm a poet. And I've been written up in the New Yorker magazine 5 years ago, and they say my poetry runs the gamut from naughty to heavy. And I thought maybe perhaps you'd like to hear a little
well,
bit.
Well, I am in the middle of finding Robin today, but if you would like to give me a short poem. I'm going to cut you off if you get lengthy, my friend, Tommaso.
Okay, here we go. Here
Where
we go.
Are you from? What planet?
And what are you dressed for?
Where is Robin?
Why are you wearing a winter coat?
I just bought it on the street. Somebody just stole it out of the men's room or something, and I bought it for $5.
You just bought a coat for $5?
Yeah, I always buy clothes.
Are you a homeless person?
Yeah, I buy rings on the street.
Oh, you're homeless.
Watches.
You're homeless?
Well, I live in a resident downtown, but I don't think I should name it. It's a big company, you know?
Yeah. You know what? I bet you kind of look like Uncle Floyd in 5 years. I'm being serious. But you're like a homeless guy.
Yeah, let me do a little bit of my poem.
All right, but you got to do it real quick, because I'm in the middle of finding that lovely woman on their date.
Okay.
I can't imagine you could interrupt this with poetry.
I'm going to tell you something. If you stop by on another day, I would let you do your poetry at a greater length.
Who told you about us?
Oh, I love you all. I hear you all the time.
Right. Now, do you go to Gary's dentist? Tommaso?
No, I'm afraid of dentists. You get it? I'm afraid of dentists.
You're afraid of dentists. I get it. Sure, I get it.
Here we go. You ready?
Who doesn't get that?
He's afraid.
Here we go.
You're afraid you're afraid of
dentists. Here we go,
dear. All right, go ahead. Here but go, quickly, I'm talking about a three-line poem here. So do some haiku, my man.
My friend George and I, we used to pee together side by side at the theater, in a restaurant, in the boys' room. We would both unzip our fly.
All right, very good. Okay, now listen to me.
What are you laughing at?
No, it's very good.
This
very
is serious
touching.
Stuff.
All right, do me a favor.
What?
I want you to return next week.
Okay.
With some of your poetry, because I'm in the middle of something. I didn't know you were coming. Gary will schedule you in so that you can do some extended poetry and we can find out more about you. You fascinate me,
all
right?
Okay, all right.
All right, I'm going to set you up with Becky, a girl.
Tommaso,
I know.
Is that Tommaso?
Yeah. Tommaso, that's the name you go by. Like Kreskin, you got one name, Tommaso.
Okay.
All right, Tommaso.
Hey, thanks so much, fellas.
Let's hope you make it through the weekend. How old are you?
Yeah, my doctor told me don't buy any long playing records.
Right. And then, do you have a family somewhere?
And he says to me, don't order no 2-minute boiled eggs.
Do you have a family somewhere that takes care of you a little bit? Or
yeah, I have lots of people who love me.
Oh, you do?
Yes, I'm very happy.
See, but you're on your own.
Yeah.
And you have no money, so you live in a shelter.
That's right.
Okay.
Sort of, yeah.
All right. Okay. Jackie, that's going to be you in 5 years.
Okay.
Yeah. That's Shakespeare over there. Oh, Tommaso, very good. Put your hat back on. No one wants to see that.
We won't keep your hat.
Scotty, beam Tommaso up. There he is. All right. There he goes. How's your feet, by the way? Yeah, do you ever have your toenails pulled out for an operation
fungus?
Or anything?
You have fungus on your toes?
Did you ever get fungus on your toenails?
I don't even know what that means.
See, Jackie, this guy's in better shape than you.
I've got a great body for my age, really.
You really do? How old are you? I'm curious.
I'm 70. Yeah.
Are you 70? I had you pegged for about 70.
Yeah, I'm 70.
Yeah, okay. In fact, you look just pretty normal for your age.
I do.
And you got long hair like a hippie.
Yeah, back in the back. I don't think I chopped, though.
No, I see that. Yeah. All right, very good.
But I'm okay, though.
You get laid at all, or is that pretty much in your past?
Well, I have people who take care of me.
I see.
Yeah.
All right, very good. All right, I'll find out more about you next week. Prepare some poems for next week. Go ahead, Tommaso.
Okay, I will. Bye-bye now. Goodbye, Robin.
Goodbye.
You know, when you walked in, I thought you were Ian Anderson. All right, go ahead. Very good. Sorry, Robin. I thought he was here for you.
Thank goodness.
I apologize.
He was not.
Where the hell did he come from? You know, it's amazing. We're on the air in New York, what, 8-9 years?
Yeah.
And, you know, you figure we've met everyone.
Nope,
anyone who's but just a new guy pops into our life. Hey, China man, move over. Tommaso's on the
stage. We've got Tommaso.
That's right. Let me think here a second. Do I want Tommaso as my main man, or do I want the great China man? Let's see. I could only find China
Man. Only find China man.
Let me hold on. Give me a second. I'm going to find him.
They put those together in a different way every day.
Every day. Yesterday, China man was right here in front of me.
That means, folks, he doesn't even see China Man. He's giving you the impression
he's
looking.
It was on here yesterday. I played it. All right, I give up. I did it yesterday. Oh, here he is. China Man.
This is Mother Teresa speaking from the bed. God don't want me yet, man. I got more feet to taste.
That's a hard act to follow.
Well, Tommaso's going to give it his best shot sometime next week.
All right, let's get to Bachelor number two. Bachelor number two, you're playing for Robin's attentions on Dial-A-Date.
Hello.
We're back, yes. Now, I thought you sounded a little creepy, but I'll be honest.
Is the creepy guy?
Yeah.
I think the creepy guy was the third guy.
The third guy. All right, so this is John.
Right.
You are number two, and you, of course, are a consultant and portfolio management guy, whatever the hell that is. You manage people's money.
Actually, I manage a credit card portfolio, securitized credit card portfolio.
I don't understand. A credit card portfolio? What does that mean?
You really want to get into this?
Yeah, I want to know what you do. I have to know.
Here's what happens. A large bank, let's say Maryland National Bank.
Right.
They get a bunch of credit card receivables.
Okay.
And if you know a little bit about balance sheets and accounts receivable.
You know what? I'm sorry I asked.
Yeah.
I'm sorry I asked.
Very complicated.
Let's talk about fun things that we'd like to do.
All right. Music, well, we're going to get to that.
Travel, this kind of thing.
Well, good. You sound very perky. You sound like you got a lot of personality. Robin likes that.
Great. She does, too.
She wants a man who is understanding and who is sensitive.
Mm-hmm.
Ultra-sensitive. In fact, you better know what she's thinking at all times.
I swear.
What IQ do you have?
Oh, I don't know. I'm a little above average, I guess.
Did you go to college?
Yes, I did.
You were a college man. What did you study in college?
Undergraduate or graduate?
Oh, you did your graduate work.
Got graduate work.
Now, what were you, a master's in business and graduate?
MBA, right.
MBA. Mm-hmm. Well, what school did you graduate?
Undergraduate, I went to Georgetown. And graduate school, I went to University of San Diego.
Well, you're no slouch. You're a smart guy.
Well, I can hear a beautiful voice when I hear one. I know what it is.
I see.
That's why I'm calling.
Now, you're so smart, you hear a beautiful voice and you know what it is.
That's right. I know I've never really seen Rob. I saw a little bit of her on one of your videos. I haven't seen, caught your TV show.
I see.
But
now, where do you live?
I live down the Jersey Shore.
Oh, that's right. You're on the Jersey Shore.
That's right.
So you don't get the TV show there? You just haven't been curious? I can't imagine someone who listens to us on the radio not tuning in just to see what the hell we're about for the week.
Well, I have a hobby. I'm a blues guitar player, and I play at night.
Another musician.
Well, then I'm going to ask you to do the same thing. Why don't you get out your guitar and play?
Unfortunately, I'm in my office.
I see. So you don't have the guitar there.
Plus, you know, I'm only 34 years old. Blues guitar players, they don't get good till they're about 40 or 42.
Now, what religion are you?
I'm a non-practicing Catholic.
You are non-practicing Catholic. No one practices Catholicism anymore, do they?
The Pope must be very upset.
As you said many times in your editorials, they have a couple of strange approaches to personal freedoms.
I see. So you're disagreeing with the church on a lot of things, and you've left the church. So all that's left in the church now are some Latinos. They go there in droves. They've got statues and all kind of things. Yeah. All the white people have left.
They've abandoned.
Uh-huh. And what is your ethnic background?
Irish and German.
You're Irish and German.
Right.
I see. Now, you say you're a fun guy.
Yeah.
Now, what do you do for fun?
Well, like I like sports. I like music. I like movies.
And what would be your ideal date with Robin? What would you like to do with her?
Well, first, I want to meet her. Right. And I want to talk to her and maybe...
You're not after her because of the radio show, are you?
I'm sorry?
You're not after her because of the radio show.
I told you I'm after her because of her voice.
You're not going to bug me, are you?
You?
Yeah, I don't want to hear that you want to meet me or anything like that. This is between you and Robin.
Then let's talk, Robin, and how would you just listen?
And well, obviously,
he's doing the interview.
And obviously,
I see.
You're into brown sugar, aren't you?
Not necessarily.
Have you ever dated a black person?
I'm sorry?
Have you ever dated a black person?
Have I ever dated a...
I said, have you ever dated a black
could
person?
You
why
that
do you have
louder?
To repeat? Why must you repeat everything I say? Robin, please, let me handle this.
I've dated non-white people, but...
oh, yes? What type of non-whites have you dated?
Orientals.
Yes.
Indians.
So you must be a pretty good-looking guy that you get all these girls.
I'm fairly good-looking, yes.
Have you, so you can classify yourself a chink lover? Wouldn't
yes,
you?
Actually, yeah.
You would, wouldn't you?
Yes, buddy.
I see. Now, is that the preferred race that you like?
Actually, I like nice people.
You just are into nice people.
I like nice people.
But if they're a chink, you give them special priority.
Actually, I'm hoping to get some special priority myself here.
I see. Now, you, the hell does that mean?
I don't know.
All right, let me pick up for you. You're throwing me off.
Three guys, I want to be number one.
I see. That's right. You want some special priority.
That's right.
Okay, I got you. You're as confusing as Jackie. Hey, are those girls slanted down there or what?
Oh, no.
All right. Anyway, here we go. Nothing like a girl can't open her eyes.
So what does he look like now?
Now, you say you're a good-looking guy, huh?
I'm 6 feet, 1 inch tall. I'm 175 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
Brown hair and green eyes.
So a lot of women do come on to you, don't they?
Yeah.
How many dates have you had within the last week?
Within the last week, only one.
Only one. And where did you meet this woman?
I met her in a actually at a university.
At a university? What? Were you lecturing? And she was a co-ed?
She was not a co-ed, but she was one of the other teachers there. I was teaching a little seminar.
So there you are talking, and immediately what? You asked her out, or she asked you out?
Actually, I asked her for a favor.
Mm-hmm. Did you make it with her? Did you score?
No, I didn't.
Did you try?
The game isn't over yet.
Right.
But we'll see.
I see. Now, what about the social diseases? You ever had any?
Nope.
You, let me ask you, do you wear a condom?
Yeah.
Why did you go, yeah?
Because it doesn't... I'm not so promiscuous that it happens all the time, and it's something I think about, except in the context of...
Are you wearing a condom as we speak?
Actually, I don't have one on right
all
now.
All right. And do you use...
One in my wallet.
When you're with your women, do you use your tongue?
Certainly.
Oh, you do?
Sure.
Robin likes that.
Oh, you. Here we go again.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to reveal personal details.
Like.
I know what you like. I know exactly what you like. You lay there like a lox, like my wife.
You have no clue.
Trust me. I've got some clue. Now, you... So you spend little time in bed face to face. Is that the correct statement?
Better than I do, Howard. If I can get a little advice, I'd appreciate it.
All right. For radio, I have to put things a certain way. You understand? We're talking a double language here. All right? When I say someone likes to be cleaned, you understand what I'm saying?
I've been listening. I'm a listener.
Okay, good. 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 You're catching on quick. I like that. All right. What I'm going to do now is do something a little unusual here. Uh-oh. I am going to put you alone in a shower with Robin. You've gotten intimate, and yes, indeed, Robin has consented to showering with you.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, you're in the shower. You're actually in there. You don't have to describe what you're doing, but... certainly, you're communicating with her. You know, Robin, I love you. You've been so special to me.
Howard.
I mean, rehearsing him, Robin. Please. All right, go ahead. You're in the shower. I'm out of the room now. Go ahead.
All right, I just want to check the temperature of the water here. Is that too warm?
No, that's fine.
That's fine. Okay.
Are you pushing her head down yet?
Oh, will you stop it?
Because I've already done that.
Oh, you're in here.
I'm already struggling with you. Come on, baby. What are you, special?
Oh, my goodness. You know, you just can't get a shower alone anymore.
All right, you guys are shy. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
And one of the fun things to do is to, I like to shampoo.
No.
Go ahead.
Put a little bit of shampoo and...
I actually like that.
Mind if I hop into this?
And kind of scratch a little bit on the scalp there, and if any soap is coming down over her eyes, I'll make sure I gently brush it out of the way. And
I noticed you haven't...
I wouldn't want any soap to get in her eyes.
Interestingly enough, you haven't even spoken to Robin in the shower.
Oh, I asked you if the water was right.
Yeah, that's the one thing you did.
Gee, Mr. Romance.
And then I just took a little shampoo and I started to rub her... Her scalp very gently.
Hey, do me a favor. Shampoo her buttocks. It's a little fuzzy today.
Oh, God.
Come on. I'm just trying to get the guy loose.
Okay, and then I'll take her by the back of the neck and bend her over backwards a little bit and wash the soap out.
Mm-hmm. All right. You've done a good job, of Mr. Clean, of scrubbing her.
My hair's done.
Why not communicate with her a little bit? Oh, Robin, you're so special. When I hear you on the air, your voice is so enticing.
Oh, she does have a beautiful voice.
Oh, yes, honey. Mm. Yes, that feels good. Mm. Come on, man. Sorry,
Howard. You lost me.
Sir, what am I in the shower here? Would you need assistance? Talk to this woman. Don't tell me you're wiping the soap out of her eyes.
Robin, I love your fingernails. You have such beautiful fingernails, and they're done so nicely.
Would you
return the favor for me here? Here, take a little bit of shampoo, and could you wash my hair and scratch my back a little bit?
Absolutely, no.
Oh,
problem.
I like that.
Hey, hang the washcloth on your weenie so you should go for it. Go ahead. That's what I want to do.
This is the longest shower.
Yeah, I mean, all this guy's doing is scrubbing you. What do you think she's
puckering.
Yeah, friggin' poodle? Just, she's clean, believe me.
Okay.
She went to bed, takes a bath every night. Go ahead, man. Get into it with her. Talk to her, man. Talk, love talk. Go ahead.
I can barely get a word in edgewise.
Go ahead.
I'd like to sit down on the floor of the tub for a little bit and just turn the shower off a little bit, maybe a little bit of water.
All right, I'm going to put you on hold. You don't know how to talk to a woman. All right, hold on, okay?
Sure.
This guy, he's sitting down on the floor. Now he's on the floor, this guy. Who is he, Mahatma Gandhi? Now I'm giving myself an enema. who cares? Talk to the woman. Hey, sweetheart, you are just beautiful. Your breasts glow, don't they? Yes. I can't wait to touch you. Yes. Your body is so wet. I like you wet. Yes. See what I mean, Robin?
Yes, well, we've never had that on the phones before, have we?
Well, Robin, I'm going to tell you something. These are two nice guys so far. I'm going to tell you something.
So far,
they're not bad. I got to say, the selection process did work. But let's give number three a fair chance, and then see which man will win the lucky date of a lifetime with Robin, who very rarely does this. Well, what if you want to do it every
week? Rarely, never. What are you talking about, rarely? What if she wants to do it every week?
Are we going to number three right away here, Fred? Yes, number three.
Ah, no break.
No break. Screw it, it's Meg's show at this point. Let her commercials back up. I'm not navigating that show. All right, number three, now's your big chance. This is the chance of a lifetime. Because Robin has never done this. Now, Richard, you say you're 30 years old, and
correct.
You you co-own an exotic car dealership. Now, you're an owner of a business.
Mm-hmm.
So that means you must have some free time to slip away every once in a while and be with Robin. But you're not too demanding, I hope, of her time.
Absolutely not.
Are you considered a bright guy by your friends?
I think so, yes.
What's the last book you read?
Actually, it was Shogun.
Shogun?
Yeah.
And why? Do you have a fascination for Oriental books?
Well, you know, little Oriental therapy in a lot of different ways is often interesting.
I see. And you read this book all on your own? No one had to help you with it?
No, I had to get a call from Hooked on Phonics to help me read it.
So you're a pretty educated guy, aren't you?
I'd say so, yes.
You went to college, didn't
yes,
you?
I did. In fact, we're alumni at Boston University.
Boston University. Now, what year did you graduate?
1983. Excuse
now, how is it that you got to own your own business? Was your father instrumental in this?
Actually, my... A dear friend of mine was in the business many years ago, and when I got out of school, he said, why don't you come on in and work mm-hmm. for me, and I did, and it turned out very well.
All right, so this dear friend of yours put you into business.
Oh, not exactly. I earned it by working
all
hard.
All right, and you built this business up along with your partner.
Absolutely.
To the point now that you own a fairly well-to-do business, don't
yes.
you? So you're a self-starter.
Absolutely.
You're not a loser, are you?
Not so good.
People don't think of you as a loser.
No, they don't.
They think of you as a winner, a guy who uses his brain power to get ahead.
Yes.
You pull yourself up by the bootstraps, don't you?
Sometimes.
Do you enjoy pornography? Most guys who pull themselves up by the bootstraps do, you know. Nothing wrong with that. It's a release. Do you like pornography?
In the movies, no, not particularly.
No,
but,
you don't watch
I totally
any...
would like to show Robin what I could do for her.
I see. You would. And you think you are pretty experienced sexually. You think you could turn her on. This is a woman who's somewhat hardened.
Hardened?
Well,
here
I'll
we
tell
go
you,
now.
You know, I was in an undisclosed building in Bayside, and I saw... Robin come down to a health club in the tightest pair of little aerobics outfits. And I can I tell you what I would do with her? I saw her sob in the parking lot, and I just rubbed the lines of this sob. I was thinking of Robin.
Wait a second. Have you been stalking Robin of some kind? Is that what you're saying to me?
Well, I was bopping this older babe in that building, and I happened to have...
Oh, you were bopping an older woman. See how I get the truth out of these guys?
Yeah.
You say you were bopping an older woman. Now, how old was this woman?
45.
45.
Extremely attractive. Very well kept.
I see. Well, you interest me. You think you're pretty much a big ladies' man, don't you?
Nah, not really. I'm really
you're pretty
guy.
Impressed with yourself, aren't you?
Absolutely.
With your business and your exotic cars
and
you're bopping
your older babes.
And you're bopping the babes and the older ones, aren't you? What about that older babe? Did she? When was her last period? Did she still get her period?
I think she was still menstruating, yes.
You do?
Yes.
She wasn't reaching for that tube of KY, was she? And how many times did you sleep with this woman?
We had an ongoing affair.
I see. And
enough to bump into Rob. Well, not bump into Rob.
But what about the stamina? Do you have a lot of stamina? Did you go one or two times or three times with her?
I'm an animal.
You're an animal.
Animal.
You can go three times in one session?
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, and what religion are you?
Jewish.
You're Jewish.
Now, I'll tell you, I am an exception for a Jewish man. Let me just say that.
Why, you're hung like a, what are you, hung like a Christian?
I, like one of the conquistadors, yes.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
I don't think you're impressing Robin. I don't think she liked that bopping the old broad thing.
Oh, Robin.
I think that turned her off. I think she thinks you think you're a little too much of a stud. That's
no,
my guess.
No, absolutely not. Robin, you like flash?
No. Your true colors came out there for a second. You know that?
Well, besides the point that he could not have possibly seen me running around in an aerobics outfit.
That's right. Robin doesn't wear an aerobics outfit. Everyone knows that.
Oh.
So how do you know it was Robin?
From the pictures.
And have you ever fantasized about Robin?
Fantasy is really what you make of it.
What does that mean?
Oh, you read that on the poster on Instagram. Now, you, wear a condom when you're with all these women?
Oh, this was a few years ago. This was mm-hmm. before all this, not-so stuff went.
I see. How often do you date?
Actually, I'm just over in a relationship for a month. I've been fairly celibate, shall we say, for the last few weeks, month or so.
All right, I'm going to do the same thing with you that I did with the last guy. I'm going to put you... Are you a good-looking guy?
I think so, yes.
Yeah, and how much do you weigh?
170 pounds.
How tall are you?
5'10".
And you consider yourself good-looking? Has anyone ever said, hey, he looks like somebody famous?
Yeah, when I was younger, I guess I'm cross between Juan Beatty and Mick Jagger.
Oh, really? But you have a big nose, right?
No.
No. Interesting.
Car accident when I was young.
Oh, so you got your nose fixed.
Well, no, it was medical reasons.
You had a nose job?
No, I did not. It was rhinoplasty.
You had a rhinoplasty?
It was for medical reasons.
Oh, what? You couldn't breathe so good?
Exactly.
Oh, I see. So you had a big nose?
I wouldn't say large, but certainly...
You are a Jew with a big nose who had a nose job, aren't you? Why are you afraid to say that?
Well, it wasn't for medical
reasons.
You
had a nose job. Don't tell me rhino for medical reasons. Everybody's medical reasons. You had a big, ugly nose.
Well, I got sort of twisted up in a car.
You look like a moneylender.
That's my stereotype, Howard.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So who planned the car accident, you or your mother?
Actually, it was Mom's idea.
I see. I had a car accident.
No,
okay,
but it was. Sure.
All right, I'm going to give you a chance to redeem yourself.
Great.
Because the other guys weren't impressive when it came to actually talking directly to Robin.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when you get in that shower, you are talking with Robin. You are alone in the shower for all of our purposes. Fred, Jackie, and I will keep our ears closed and keep our mouths shut. And you are in the shower with this woman.
Without Fred, Jackie, and everybody.
You know, you strike me as the kind of guy, I got to tell you one thing. Let me turn off the shower for a second, Fred. I got a feeling you might be called. Don't waste water. Right. The mayor said we have a shortage.
That's right.
Mayor Dinkins. There's no shortage coming out of his forehead, but...
That's where we're going to have to get our supply.
All he has to do is lean over the reservoir, and I think in a minute we'll have enough water. Smell a bit, too?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I knew we'd find an opening to the TV show. All right, so... Mayor Dinkins leaning over a reservoir. There is a water shortage, but I will help you. People say I'm a bad mayor, but I think I can right this wrong. And then boom, all the water just filling the entire... But then we have a shot of him filling an entire reservoir. And then the dam's going and all that stuff.
Yes, just overflowing and flooding everything.
It's going to be good. Thank you for helping me write that, sir.
You were an inspiration.
You were inspirational in some way, some bizarre way. Now, you know what strikes me about you? That you would date Robin and tell all your friends that you're dating Robin. That's the... And tell the truth. In a way, it's kind of like that. You wouldn't mind dating a celebrity, would you?
Well, it's not the celebrity status. I think Robin's a very, very sexy one.
But you've never dated a celebrity, have you?
No, I have not dated.
It would be bad conversation, cocktail conversation, for you to tell people, hey, guess who I just had a date with? Robin Quivers from the Howard Stern Show.
Mm-hmm. Well, I wouldn't actually do it that way.
Be a little more subtle about it.
But you do it.
Well, I wouldn't go back. I had a date with Robin Quivers. I mean, it's not like it's the...
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, fair enough. Okay, I'm going to put you in the shower. I'm going to now quiet myself down.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you are nude. Robin is nude. She's there. Her beautiful breasts are pouting.
Mm-hmm.
Her thighs scream for attention.
Mm-hmm.
The flatness of her belly. Her eyes are looking up at you like a puppy dog. There's a very serious look on her face. She looks as if she needs a man. She still has that independence, that aura of independence around her, but she needs a man right now to take her... To take her. A very big man. A man with a nice new nose.
Hello.
Go ahead. You're alone.
I'm alone? I would lick Robin in places. That
well,
only,
go ahead. Don't
delay.
Only
a 7-second delay.
No. Talk to her first. You're in the shower with her.
You're talking to me.
She is
Richard.
In there. You're in there.
Howard's not here.
Yes, Richard. I'm gone. Don't tell us what you would do. Say, Robin, I like you. I like how you feel to my touch. Your breasts are so beautiful. With your permission, I would like to do the following. Go ahead.
Robin?
Yeah, hi.
Hi. Would you make the water a little warmer, please?
Hey, get me in that shower with Robin.
Sure. You've been in the shower all along.
What I would love to do to you, I could not even say on here. I would stroke your thighs, run my hands up your legs, slowly caress you everywhere. I would put my tongue in places that you never even dreamed of. Then I would fulfill you with my masculinity.
I'm sorry, I'm not in here. Go ahead, Robin. Well, what do you have to say? He just said something very romantic to you. He wants to fulfill you with his
masculinity. Wait a minute, I'm laughing. That's what I'm
saying. This guy's watched a few porno movies. Or he's read a few books.
I'm going to fulfill you.
With my masculinity.
Oh, I was looking for the appropriate word.
That was very good. That was very good because it's hard to... Go ahead, Robin. Look, she's laughing at him.
Robin. None of that sounds interesting to you.
Oh, goodness. You really talk like this, huh?
He's going limp.
I'm trying.
Hey, Robin, come on. Get in the shower. You dead kind of turned you on.
No, is this the way he really talks?
Well, talk to him. You're in the shower. Why do I have to be
wait a minute. If he says this to me, that is definitely going to be my reaction.
You're going to laugh?
Yes. That's right. Silly.
Oh, how about set that up? That's not my fault.
No, you have to do what you're going to do.
Well,
don't be a lemming.
I tell you, it would start with a lovely evening. Can I tell you how the evening
All right, thank
go?
You. Well, hold on. I'm going to put you on hold. All right? Not very inventive. All right. You had a woman there. You were talking
to her. That was close, wasn't I?
Yeah. You were one-on-one, and you blew it.
Yeah. I tried.
Robin, you're so sweet. Yes. Robin.
You know, what about, we had a great evening.
I can tell about all
you. Robin, I got to tell you something. When I'm with you,
it's so much fun to be with you. I just really enjoy your company.
Thank you, Robin. And let me say something to you. Not only do I enjoy your company, but I've never felt at ease with a woman like this before.
Really?
And I must confess something to you. Having heard you on the radio casually, I used to listen to you, and I thought you were always very bright and entertaining, but mm-hmm. I never realized just how much fun I could ever have with someone I'd heard. I mean, this is just a fantasy come true for me.
Well, I've had a lot of fun with you, too. Yes. I never thought this dial-a-date thing would work out like this.
Would you mind if I soaped your breasts right now?
Well, go ahead.
Really? Well, thank you. You see what I mean? A little sweet talking right away. I'm already got the bar of soap on there.
Hey, you're a pro.
That's right.
I'm not that slick-tongued.
I'm not a pro. Let me tell you something. I'm
not
a pro.
That slick-tongued.
No. All right. Very good. Hold on. Guys are all losers. I'm going to talk to a woman. You got to just have a little bit of a rap. Yeah, look who's giving advice. I was married at 24 because nobody else would do me. All right, here we go. Let me review for you, Robin.
All right.
This is a big decision.
Jeez. I have to make a decision.
Well, the boys will also give up. Well, first
give
let me run
opinions,
down.
Opinions, yes. Yeah.
And whatever Jackie's opinion is, discard it.
Right away.
Right. But we will hear from Jackie. All right, number one is Ash, or Ashley. I liked his whole thing with the plane. That was very different. Very unusual guy. A lot of homos grab his ass. He push-ups, does the push-ups to keep in shape, Robin. But he doesn't really need to work out that hard because he's got a good physique.
Mm-hmm.
He's a corporate pilot. Flies out of Westchester. His idea of a romantic date is to fly you to Virginia and give you some breakfast and take you to Key West for lunch. He's never had sex with a plane on autopilot. He can't remember his IQ, but he thinks it's pretty high. And quite frankly, he went to Embry-Riddle Plane College, which everybody's heard of. And with the impressive SATs of 500 on each, you can see why he got in. But hey, brains aren't everything. Meanwhile, he's a corporate pilot. Which is a glorified limo driver.
Look, we tried to fly that simulator. You know, piloting
it's
a little bit harder than that.
Yes, it is. He likes dice. He's not promiscuous. Loves your milk wagons. And your smile. He thinks you're pretty. And he looks like JFK or David Cassidy.
I don't know how they look
alike.
I know,
but all right. Neither one of them are slouches. Number two is John. He's 34 years old. He's 6 foot, 175 pounds. And I must confess to you, when I first heard his voice, I thought he was a little dull, but he turned out to be a firecracker. Had brown hair, green eyes, and he manages credit card portfolios, which was really boring. But yet he came alive when he confessed to us that he had his MBA from the University of San Diego and studied at Georgetown with his undergraduate work.
Mm-hmm.
He lives on the Jersey Shore with his own home. He owns his own home. I wonder if number three owns his own home. Let me just check that out for you. Hold on. Hey, number three, you own your own home?
Yeah.
You do?
Oh, I'm sorry?
You own your own home?
Yes, it is. Condo.
Owns his condo. Hold on. See, these guys are a little more relaxed. We just grab them quick. This guy hasn't seen you on the TV show, which is kind of interesting. He's not a huge fan. You know what I mean? He's just,
yeah.
Blues guitar player. Likes sports and music. Irish and German descent. Has dated Orientals and other ethnics. Only had one date in last week. Wears condoms and uses his tongue. Interesting little note you put here, Fred. I'm not going to read that note just yet.
Ooh.
I'll let you give that opinion on the air.
I have to know what that is.
Well, you'll know. Number three is Richard. Interesting note there, too, Fred.
What is Freddie doing over there?
Fred wrote a little note on this sheet of paper.
Okay.
I can see already who Fred is favoring, but... but don't put too much credence in Fred.
I'll listen to everyone, and then I'll make my decision.
He co-owns an exotic car dealership, and he last book he read was Shogun. He graduated BU in 1983, and his friend put him into business, but he did it all on his own, you know.
Worked hard.
He has seen Robin, and he says he's an animal. He was in a car accident, therefore had to get a nose job, if you want to believe that. He's Jewish, and he got over a relationship 1 month ago. He looks like Warren Beatty and Mick Jagger. And he's 170 pounds and 5 foot 10 in good shape. Now, let's go around the room. First, Jackie. Jackie, you heard all three men. What would you advise Robin?
I think she should go out with the pilot because he sounded the perkiest and the most fun. Plus, I think we'll all get to ride in the plane.
All right.
You can take me to visit my brother in Virginia.
All right. So you'll be
on the date.
Jackie will be on the date.
He sounded the coolest.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Fred,
Where were Fred's notes?
Yeah.
Fred, do you want to... You know what your notes were.
No, I don't remember what I wrote that interested you.
All right. Well, I mean, number one's note was lots of homos grab his ass. Number two's note was he seemed a little bit jivey.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
He just seemed a little... I don't know. It's like he didn't seem honest. Like he was trying a little too hard and just was falling short.
Yeah, I didn't get that impression of number two, but okay, I'll give my opinion in a minute. And number three, you said sounds like a deranged fan.
I think he does. I mean, you know, like the whole interchange where he said he saw Robin coming down the stairs in the aerobic outfit.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. It sent a chill up my spine.
Howard, you better remember.
Yeah.
Fred knows dial date.
Well, that's right, but don't. But he lucked out once. Fred, we can send Fred out on the next 9 days.
Yeah, we haven't had Freddie on five dial dates.
Yeah. And I got a feeling no matter who he picks, he would have. As long as somebody paid attention to him, he would pay attention to them back. I'm going to be honest with you on that. I think if he picked any of the other girls, he'd be marrying them. Now, no offense, Fred. I don't mean to put you down.
No.
All right. Now,
that wasn't a put down.
Number one is a very good guy. But the one thing, I'm going to tell you something. Number one and number two struck me both as being very good guys. Number three, forget about it. I'm with Fred on that one.
He's totally out.
Number three is out, as far as I'm concerned. Now, that could be something totally different, because everybody has their own thing. The thing I liked about number two was he was a little bit older.
But I don't believe he's never seen her on TV.
No, I thought he was sincere. He said he saw her a couple of times. He saw her on one of our videotapes. You know, Fred, believe it or not, there are people who haven't viewed our TV.
Who have lives and don't stay home on Saturday nights.
Oh, yeah. Remember your life before you met your girlfriend?
But I admit if I watched a TV show or I've seen somebody.
But do you think he's lying about something like that?
I don't know. Why would he lie?
Let's talk to him.
I think he's trying to be casual. He's trying to appear unanxious.
Let me ask you something. I'm trying to defend you right now. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I think you really are sincere when you say you haven't seen the TV show.
I've never. Well, Saturday night I play. If I can get, if I have.
You go to clubs and play your guitar.
Yeah. But I have, like I said, I saw her on, what's the one with the tennis sores?
U.S. Open Tennis.
Yeah, I saw that one.
Right. Okay, hold on, all right?
Okay.
All right, listen. My opinion is this. Take away the plane from number one. Take away the fact that he is a pilot for a second. Take that away from him. Was he still better than number two? That's what you must ask yourself.
But you're not going to take away anything from number two?
Number two doesn't have anything to take away. We don't even know what number two does. We can't even figure it out. I also like number two's age, that he's 34 years old.
Uh-huh.
I like that. I'm not saying you shouldn't date younger men. But I think this guy might have a little more in common with you, just because of the age factor. Was anybody going to disagree with me on that? 27 is awfully young. That don't mean I want to be dating a 27-year-old.
He also likes to hang around with people who think young.
Well, this guy don't sound old, number two. I am not going for number one versus number two. I'm just saying, take away the plane from number one. And is he still great? And if he is still great, then I would choose number one. But I thought number two was a pretty cool guy.
That is your considered opinion.
But I would, I'd go for the pilot.
Why would you take away the plane?
Because I'm talking about a guy's personality. Just because he flies a plane, she's not going to be in the plane every 5 minutes, Jackie.
But that's the kind
with
of...
With you there going to Virginia with her.
You can take away the plane, but the kind of thing that makes a guy... So pilots are always adventurous,
fun type
people.
In order to make him acceptable, you're saying they got to spend all their time on a plane.
No, not at all. What drives somebody to become a pilot, they're usually interesting, fun people.
Usually. Have you ever met some of the guys who walk down the aisle on some of these flights? You want to vomit.
No. Have you ever heard them on that little loudspeaker thing?
I have a couple friends that are pilots, and they're good guys.
If you look down on them, everybody's a good guy to you. Charles Manson's a good guy to you.
Listen, I love everybody, and I don't like number three.
Yeah, I know. We all hate number three.
Yeah, apparently number three's out.
Number three, as soon as he said he was banging the old babes in the building. You know, because any guy who knows, listens to you, knows you ain't going to dig that. I broke him down enough to make him show his true colors.
Yeah.
All right. I was patting myself on the back. All right, Robin, now it's time to decide. Will it be number one?
I gotta make a decision.
Will it be number two or number three? And let's say something here. This decision is important because Fred found actual real romance on this, and it could turn into something.
Oh, well, now, let's not get far afield here.
Don't worry, nobody's saying you're like Fred. That's what you're afraid.
You know, this is a pretty big event. Do you think Tom will be sending them someplace special?
No.
What are you? Jackie, just shut up. Dope. Worry about your toes.
I'm going to choose.
I know what it is. I'm going to write down my prediction.
All right. Everybody write down what they think I'm going to say.
And don't be contrary.
I'm vacillating even now.
Right.
Vacillating.
And Robin, no, you can't have two guys. You can only have one.
I can't.
I wrote, Gary, you wrote down your prediction? Oh, good.
For sure. Well,
a shoe-in, they say. I'm not so sure. All right.
No, that means you're shoeing Gary's mouth. All right, here we go. Let me just see. Everybody has written down the same thing.
Oh, wow.
That's
all right.
Interesting.
Bachelor number two.
Oh, you're kidding. Are you picking him just to be contrary?
No. She's
not going to grow.
All right, number two.
Oh, man.
Number one. We all wrote down number one.
You're kidding.
No, we all wrote down number one. Now, what persuaded you to pick Bachelor number two?
It was probably what you said about take the plane away.
Mm-hmm. Well, that was a stupid thing to listen to.
That made no sense.
That was the stupidest thing I've said all morning.
You control her.
Number,
so
she
much.
Liked
no, no, no,
number.
No, no.
I don't control her.
No,
totally
it was.
Control.
If you take the plane away, he's a very nice 27-year-old guy.
I like what you did. Hey, Jackie, don't ruin romance here. Remember Fred? We all thought he picked the wrong girl.
He was the most sincere.
Fred,
what?
This is just like your date. We all thought you picked wrong.
No, Fred picked the sincere one.
Yeah.
Not the one that...
Oh, shut up, yeah.
I didn't think there was anything
I liked that she was
kind.
That was now
two.
That was mind-blowing. Hi, number one.
Hello.
Robin,
I'm sorry.
Robin went insane and picked number two.
Can I change my mind?
She picked number two. Yes, hello.
Yeah, she picked number two.
Yeah,
it wasn't because of my age, was it?
No.
Okay.
I think it was. Let me tell number three the bad news, too. Let me get you both on. Number three, you there?
Yes.
Yeah, both of you guys are losers, number one and three.
Well, I'm sorry. I think you picked the wrong one.
Who's that saying that, three?
Number one.
No, number one.
You know what? I thought she'd pick you.
Yeah.
But you
it
know what?
It was very close.
It was very close, and look, you didn't get it.
I could only take one.
Well, if it doesn't work out with number two...
Well, no, we can't play that game.
Oh, I can play that game.
No, you can't. Gary, I want this number destroyed.
No, you don't. You dare.
Yes, it is. Robin, that's
Stop
the game.
Or else you're being so mean.
No, no, no.
And Robin?
Yes?
I'm not a Drains fan. I was given bad advice by someone that knows her. That's in my office. I'm sorry.
What is this you're saying?
I was
you were given
bad
advice
by somebody in my office that knows
No one knows guess. Me.
Yeah, Harris.
What is he saying?
He's saying that there's somebody that knows Robin that he knows office. That gave him advice.
So you never even saw Robin? You never even saw Robin anywhere?
No, I did not.
No, so why did you lie?
The lies were coming through.
I was given bad advice.
By Harris?
Yeah.
Harris hardly knows me.
Oh, he's a bit.
Oh, who is this? Is this that Harris from Wayne's
yeah.
Place? Oh, boy. Oh, now you see, you should have been honest. We saw right through you.
I'm not a Grange fan.
All right, number one and three, I'm sorry you didn't win. I'm going to go over and talk to number
All right,
two. Thank you guys for calling in.
All right.
Sorry,
All right.
Ash.
Ash. Ash. That's another thing, Ash. Ain't got any good Ash. Number two, you win.
All right.
Wow, where's the trumpets, Fred? Get the hell with it.
Trumpets before.
Wow. I'm sorry, number two?
I'm a little scared here.
Well, don't be scared and don't be nervous about
what
it.
What are you scared of?
Well, you know, you're a pretty famous lady, and I'm kind of a private guy, and, what's the chances?
But, what are the chances of the two
well,
of you?
Well, yeah, you're sounding like a loser. Let me go back to number one.
You know, she's real sorry she picked you. You sound like a good guy to me, and I think it's going to be a very successful date.
All right. Yeah. Well, we'll do our best.
Don't try to bang her the first date. That turns her off. Go for it the second or third. You can make out with her the first if she likes you.
Get out of here.
And just try to get a good read on it, all right? You don't want to scream and date rape.
Hey, let's just talk and eat something and see what happens. That's all.
Right.
How's that?
That sounds nice.
Yeah.
You mean me and you or her and you? Oh, all right. You mean Robin.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Very good. Hold on, okay?
Okay.
Well, there's your dream, man.
Thanks,
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Don't be too aggressive. Kiss her on the... You know what? Wash your hands just in case. But... All right, hold on. Why not? You never know.
You've
made love to a guy on a first date,
no.
haven't you? Never?
Not in years. Not in years.
Years ago, but you have in the past.
That was before.
Before.
Oh, you.
That's terrible.
Get out of here. Like, you didn't.
Easy.
You didn't even have a date.
I would if I could have.
You were just begging girls to sleep with you. There was no date involved.
No dating needed here. My father supports me. Well, Robin, I'm excited that this date will happen and that you will finally meet someone from the audience.
You know, now I'm regretting not taking it.
I know. You know what? He sounded really bad when we just spoke to him. No, you got to go with number two. And you want to know something? You got to go with your first instinct.
I was vacillating. Vacillating.
Yeah, that's
crazy.
Okay. There's a reason that for some reason you went to number two.
Yeah.
Stick with that. You'll be miserable.
Nah, thank you.
No, you're going to be fine. It's going to be great, and I can't wait to hear about this.
I hope this never happens. Mm.
Believe me, I only wish I was dating. But my wife would kill me. All right. Well, that was exciting, Robin.
Wow.
You made the show today.
A whole day of this.
Wow. Who thought that Robin would have picked number two?
I'm shocked that all you guys...
We all wrote down number one. Number one was a great guy. And Jackie was right. A guy who's a pilot, those are adventurous guys. They're like...
And they're relaxed. They can handle all kinds of pressure. They're just fun.
And he's not after your money.
I've
secure.
Known pilots, too. You forget I was in the Air Force.
Oh, that's right. Ooh, good point. But I'm telling you, number two was a good guy. When we interviewed him, the guy didn't break once. He was really good.
He was cool.
You can't forget that. Even though he sounded like a dweeb when he won. And the guy was honest. Hey, I'm a little bit nervous. The guy called a radio show and won a date.
She's going to be sitting there at dinner and thinking about being in the plane and everything.
Number one could have been a little too cocky for her. The guy's got a little, you know, he's just got a little.
Number one?
Yeah, he might be thinking a little too much of himself.
Nah, the way he played that guitar, he wasn't thinking too much of himself at all.
All right. Yeah, maybe that was what did it.
Well, I forgot about the guitar.
The way he was playing that guitar.
That wasn't such a bad choice.
Yeah.
Hey, you know one thing? When he did that, I said, now, I'm going to have to sit around listening to this.
Yeah, let me tell you some Chuck Woolery laughs at that guy's musical abilities. Robin, we're very late, but is there any story you need to wrap up with?
Well, let me just tell you that Warren Beatty says monogamous sex is the most exciting. You'll be happy to hear that.
How would he know that?
Well, he has been monogamous.
For like a week.
Right. Well, that's monogamy.
Yeah, great.
And he says that being in love with one woman is a very exciting sexual thing.
This is a guy who really is not a stable guy in my estimation.
Not at all.
You know, this is a guy who, at some point you do get a little maybe you don't. I don't know, but... Who knows? Maybe he's nuttier than his sister.
Really? Also, what was the other thing I read about him today that made me take pause? I don't know if I'll be able to find it quickly.
Well, you're a little shook up. Got a big date.
Shaken up?
You're a little excited, aren't you, over there? Look at you.
No, I don't even know when this is going to happen. Why would I be excited?
It's happening tomorrow night.
No way.
Are you booked already?
Yeah, I'm busy.
What are you going to wear, Robin? Sexy outfit?
Practically booked.
What do you mean? What's it happening?
Well, we're already picking out. We're going to do a special restaurant for Robin.
Really?
Yeah, because we want it to be right, and we're hoping to do it either this week or the following week.
Oh, dear.
Very good.
Want to get it right on.
Get it right. Get it going. In fact, what are you doing this weekend, Robin?
Saturday night?
What are you doing Saturday night?
I'm busy.
What are you doing Sunday night?
I don't do anything Sunday night. It's the day before work.
What are you doing tonight?
I'm busy.
What are you doing?
I'm not telling you what I'm doing.
Hmm. You're going on a date, aren't you?
I did not say that.
Are you going out with friends or are you going out on a date?
I didn't say what I was doing.
What, now you can't even discuss if you're going out with friends? I mean, what is going on in this show? Hey, tell Swan to take a hike. This is your weekend and you'll do what you want.
I didn't say anything about him.
Are you doing this to get him jealous?
No.
All right, go ahead. What else did you want to add?
What else did I want to add? I was looking for that other thing I read about Warren Beatty. Oh, they know it's a girl. They've had the test.
Good.
So they're having a little girl, he and Annette Bening. And River Phoenix makes a revelation. He was interviewed...
Detail Magazine.
By Details Magazine. You know about this, huh?
I know about everything.
Oh, you do
I'm
not.
An expert on everything.
You didn't know who I was going to pick.
Well, I certainly made you screw up your choice. Do enough to do that.
He says that he lost his virginity at the age of 4. They said 14? No, at age 4. But I was completely celibate from the age of 10 to 14. He's now 21 years old.
How did he do that?
His partners were kids.
Wow.
But he blocked most of it out. He admits he wishes he'd waited, adding, I haven't had sex with many people, five or six, but it is possible to have sex at the age of four.
You weren't that his babysitter, were you?
No. That according to some sex expert.
Wow.
Teresa Crenshaw, specialist in human sexuality in San Diego.
That could have happened. I remember.
She's had a handful of male patients report to her that as children, 4 or 5 years of age, they were able to have erections.
It's possible.
And subsequent sexual activity. So there.
I know a girl got it when she was two.
Oh, come on.
From River Phoenix. Just kidding. Four. You can't even, you don't even know what you're doing when you're four. How dare you? I don't believe that for a minute.
Not for a minute, huh?
I was 16.
Four is considerably younger. And that's what's happening.
Those lucky hairless boys giving it four. Now, what can I say? I don't believe that for a minute, by the way. Not for a minute. Don't think it's possible.
Hmm.
What do you think of that?
Well, it is possible.
I know. I'm hung like a four-year-old.
But whether he's telling the truth, we do not know.
No, he's not telling the truth. He thinks in his mind he got it. Maybe there was some experimentation and some rubbing, but he did not get it.
Okay. Well, that's what's happening, folks.
Kindergarten, possibly. Probably couldn't wait to get to kindergarten just to tell the other guys.
You know, he was a cute little boy.
Well, I'm sure. All little boys are pretty cute.
Well, he was an exceptionally cute little boy.
Well, Robin,
And do you want to talk about your vindication?
Well, I was going to, I was going to talk about it, but
I didn't know whether to do that or not.
Well, it is a news story. You want a statement? You know, the press was calling me for a statement. If you want a statement, I'll give you one.
Would you give us a statement, please? You've been cleared. The judge has thrown out the case against you that was filed by Mark Glickman of Flushing, Queens. He was suing you for, I think, an exorbitant sum of $500 million.
Oh, I don't think that's exorbitant. I have that kind of cash on me today, so. No, I will say that I expect it to be cleared. I want to thank the court for clearing my name. I thought the court's decision was very brilliant. It's almost pathetic what goes on in the courts today with frivolous lawsuits. And the intelligence of the court here was, well, it was one that I expected, but yet you never know nowadays. This was totally frivolous in my estimation. I did nothing wrong. I did nothing to hurt anyone, and I think that that was between a husband and wife, whether or not he liked her actions, and I hope that they certainly get together and discuss whatever problems they may have, you know, in terms of this particular incident. And that's it. Case closed. I knew that this would be the outcome.
And they could have just saved a lot of time.
Right, and I thought that the judge exhibited extreme intelligence. So what can I say? We still have some good judges out there, and we still have sometimes our legal system works, and that proves it.
All right.
All right?
That's it, then.
All right. Very good. 1048, 92.3 K-Rock, WYSP, WJFK. And let me remind you that Jackie Penhouse, Joke Page, Martling, Halloween night, Thursday, October 31st at Governor's Comedy Shop in Levittown on Long Island. Free album with admission. I do think it's interesting, though, that the article in the Post was buried next to porn pics may help cops. And it was a little tiny square when this story broke.
It was a big, big story.
Yeah. Halloween night, Thursday, October 31st at Governor's Comedy Shop in Levittown on Long Island. Free album with admission. For jokes and information, dial 516-922-WINE. His 13 Wild Party cassettes available at All Tower Records and Sam Goody's on both coasts. Also, Boy Gary tonight at the Trocadero in Philadelphia from 8 to 10 p.m. for the new happy hour. And don't miss Josie Sang appearing at Dick Lee's on Kings Highway in the Belmar, New Jersey. In Belmar, New Jersey?
The Belmar or in Belmar?
In Belmar, New Jersey. 10 minutes outside of Philly tomorrow night. For more information, call 609-931-4802. Pig Vomit tomorrow night at the Backstreet Cafe on Route 35 in Katona, New York. And if you're planning a wedding or party and want a mobile DJ, call Scott the Engineer's Rockin' Entertainment at 718-BAG-5040. You know, that's that, Robin. That was exciting. That was really exciting. No. I'm happy for you if it works out.
Nothing. You know, we'll have a dinner. I think that could work out.
Hey, that's right. The dinner will work out, and then I hope there's some amour. Oh, whatever. I thought I gave a particularly good grilling to those guys.
Yeah, and then you steered me wrong.
Oh, now I'm the one who steered you wrong.
Yeah.
I just said, evaluate in your heart if the guy wasn't a pilot, and you said to yourself that you have met many pilots and it doesn't turn you on that lifestyle. What would turn you on about a guy flying you up to Virginia for breakfast? The hell, you want to die in one of those small planes?
I love those small planes, actually.
Well, yeah, well, you're not going to be in one. You're going to be with some guy who does some job we don't know what the hell it is. Probably was lying about that.
Oh, goodness.
All right, here's Cecilia for you. Go hang yourself to this. All right, 10:50, 10 in front of 11 o'clock, 92.3 K-Rock, YSP, JFK, Los Angeles, and JFK AM Baltimore.